morning, everyone. Thank you for spending this time with us. So this is a free lecture on reinforced concrete. So fundamentals lang tayo, no? Yung reinforced concrete, particularly flexure. So free ito, wag na lang tayong makinig na lang tayo. Wala lang sana yung mga comment na medyo below the belt kasi merong iba na free na nga, nagre-reklamo pa, di ba? So free lang to, with raffle pa rin tayo but not as many as the usual namin na raffle. So salamat sa lahat. So I know marami dito mga undergraduate. So bali yung focus natin dito ngayon, principle lang. In fact, I will not make this a board-oriented lecture. Da? Yung pwedeng magamit talaga natin sa undergraduate natin. Kasi meron kasing pang lecture na pang board. Ano eh? Pang board eh. No? Yung pag, kasi alam niyo naman, pag design code yan eh. So depende yan sa interpretation din ng author or ng examiner. Minsan meron siya mga ginagawang assumptions na hindi naman yun nasa code. Kaya yan, ginagawa namin yan sa review. Pero kung focus lang tayo sa code talaga para talaga maging ano generic yung ating discussion. Ayan. So meron, of course we will be mentioning about our, iset ko lang mamaya yung party sa aming review. So we will be mentioning it also na as part of our campaign na rin. But basically itong lecture na to is focus talaga sa concrete, na? Well, if kung maraming manunood, maganda yung response sa araw na to, then we might offer another set, na? Continuation. Mabaga, mamaya na, tingnan natin, no? Baka hindi nyo naman magustuhan yung ating lecture. So again, hindi ito pang board. Although, wow, you might be wondering, bakit hindi pag board? Yung board ba iba sa code? Pareho, no? Pareho, pero alam nyo, depende din yan sa knowledge. Hindi naman, I'm not saying na hindi siya knowledgeable, pero sa exposure ng examiner. Examiner kasi kayo medyo mga terms ginagamit niya, may halo pang yung dating code, no? Pero ito talaga, I will be presenting you the code and then we will be discussing, no? What it meant, no? Para sa ating design. So I do hope na tawag dyan, majority sa inyo aware na rin or familiar na rin sa code o nagbabasa ng code, kumbaga, ha? Kung nagbabasa ng code. Alright, so this is 2015 NSCP. So I welcome, no? Lahat-lahat. So marami ng viewers natin, 163 ang nakapag sign up or nakapag member. Sa ngayon, we have, andali, hatinan ko kung ilan na ba yung total members as of now. 1,400. Maraming mga late requests dito. Ha? Sige, i-approve ko lang. Pero we have to answer, no? The question also, yung membership question, at least yung school ninyo. Okay, so bawal lang mag-ano, ha? Bawal mag-advertise. Ano lang tayo? Observe lang tayo ng ano? Discipline. Ayan. Alright, so may mga late requests dito. Ayan. So please make sure to answer the membership question for you to be approved. Meron doon, at least what school, anong, okay, sagutan nyo lang. This is free, walang ano dito, wala namang bayad to. No? And we have this Padlet link, you can see this in the post. You can ask question there, that's anonymous. No? So hindi kayo makikilala no? Kung may mga tanong kayo. May mga tanong-tanong kayo. So we can't expect to be master of this subject in this lecture then. Ang ano lang dito is yun lang. To compare what you have learned and anyway, lahat naman to dito sa code. So code talaga yung ano natin. Hindi lang hindi lang to in my opinion, talagang codependent tayo para walang masyadong maraming wala nang maraming debate, okay? So again, good morning everyone. Magandang umaga sa lahat. Maupay nga aga ha mga waray, mayag nga aga sa mga kasi manwa ko na sa Bacolod kag Iloilo blaw, ha? Okay, mapiya mapita, lumang pagkari ko do sa Maguindanao, sa Mindanao. O sa mga isuna ko nga mga Maranao, mga ano, maayo nga buntag, ha? Okay, maimbag na bigat sa mga Ilocano ko nga mga Ilocano, JJ Banger. All right, medyo marami tayong alam na dialect, pero ano talaga, Cebuano yung aming talagang salita. But in the review, meron din kami namang full online review, Tagalog-English tayo. Tagalog-English tayo. So, ayan. Okay? 185 viewers. Sige lang. I know some of you are sharing the screen. So, I believe there are more than 185 viewers pa. And with regard to the raffle, no? So, make sure that you are watching when your name is called. And then, I will wait for your response by Facebook. Hindi na ako tatawag, no? Pag mag-reply kayo, response kayo na, nandyan kayo, then, yeah, winner ka. Na? Meron tayong free books, 2 books of your choice, and 50% discount in our online review and refresher. Ayan. Okay. Sige, simulan natin, ha? Simulan natin. Sige, we have 9:09 na. I bet baka abot tayo ng 11:30 kung okay lang. Tinan ko lang yung audience kung marami pang matitira by that time. Okay. By the way, after this live lecture natin, you can still watch the replay. No? It will stay in our Facebook group, no, for a while. And then we will put this sa aming YouTube channel. Okay. After 2 days, 3 days, so ilalagay namin sa YouTube. Free pa rin siya. Doon namin ilalagay sa YouTube channel namin. Okay. Sige. Simulan natin. Litan ko lang yung mukha ko, no? Bali, message nyo lang ako pag minsan yung mukha ko natatabunan yung mga nasa screen. Minsan kasi nakaka-cover siya. Right? So, handa na ba kayo? Ha? O, thumbs up naman dyan. Ha? Are you ready now? Ha? Okay. Sige. Ready na ba mo, tanan? Ha? Oh. Reply. Okay, yes po. Okay, thank you so much. Dalang ha, check ko lang muna to. Okay, sige, ready na tayo ha. Ready na tayo. So stay neutral lang tayo ngayon. Of course, we will insert our review center also, but Wala tayong ano. Huwag natin sabihin, sa review center, walang ano dito. Walang pakialam yung ibang review center dito. Kumbaga, ano lang, neutral lang. Kahit saan review center kayo, accepted kayo. Huwag natin ilagay sa mind natin, iba naman yung sinabi dun sa amin. Mali naman yan, wag. Ano lang, makinig lang tayo sa discussion. Alright, so particular tayo, diretso tayo, flexure. I know dito maraming nalilito. Okay, let me have this checking. Huh? Okay, ano ba yung, sige daw, ano ba yung, let me ask nyo, to check kung talagang aware kayo lahat, no? Ano ba yung maximum row sa 2015 NSCP? Sige daw, ano ba yung row max? Huh? Ano yung row max? Let me hear from you. Dahil ha, binubuksan ko lang yung code. Buksan ko lang yung code. Dali, sakto na. Well, AS over BD, yes. No? Pero ano ba yung raw maximum? Ano yung formula ng raw maximum? Ayan. Okay. Ay. Anyway, sige lang, tingnan natin. Ah, sige. Okay, 2015 NSCP. Ito, basa muna tayo ng code. Particularly, on flexure. On flexure tayo. Alright, sige daw. We will be reading the code. We will be very dependent. May nagsabi dito, 0.75 raw balance. May din nagsabing 200 over FY. Okay, so we'll be dependent on this. Interpretin natin. No, I will first derive the formula, especially for rectangular beam, and then magdi-discuss tayo ng dalawang ano lang, dalawang problem. Isa doon sa analysis or investigation, isa naman doon sa design. Sana abutin natin yung 2 hours. Sana matapos natin to ngayon. Na? Okay, we will try. Okay, sige. So ito yung design assumption, ha? So, the assumptions of moment and axial strength. So, by the way, hindi lang ito pang moment itong ating discussion ngayon. Kasali na rin yung axial. Okay? Equilibrium and strain compatibility. So, dapat ma-observe. Sandali lang ha. Kukunin ko lang yung pen ko. Sandali. Yung pen ko, kalimutan kong i-prepare. Ayan, equilibrium and strain compatibility, no? And then, equilibrium shall be satisfied at each section. Strain in concrete and non-pre-stressed reinforcement shall be assumed proportional to the distance. So, proportional to the distance. So, strain, no? Hindi stress. Iba ang stress, iba yung strain. So, the strain is proportional to the distance from the neutral axis. Okay? And ito yung mga assumptions sa code. So, maximum strain at extreme concrete compression fiber shall be assumed equal to 0.003. And then, the tensile strength of concrete shall be neglected in flexural and axial strength calculation. So, neglected daw. And then, the relationship between concrete compressive stress and strain shall be presented by a rectangular stress, no? Trapezoidal or any other shape. But we are using the rectangular, no? Ito yung ginagamit natin sa equivalent rectangular concrete stress distribution. And ito yung assumption. Okay? Kalimutan nyo muna yung mga formula, no? Yung mga RN, RN na yun, omega na yun. Wag muna yun, wag muna yun. Kasi actually, pwede natin masolve ang concrete without those formulas. We will just rely on the strain assumption and equilibrium. Ganun lang naman talaga. Pagdating sa flexure, hindi mo naman kailangan ng formula. Well, of course, there are lots of uses of that formula that will make your solution short. But maganda talaga pag alam mo yung principle. Na? Alam natin yung principle. So, a concrete stress of 0.85 FC prime shall be assumed uniformly distributed over an equivalent compression zone bounded by the edges of the cross-section and a straight line parallel to the neutral axis, a distance of A, which is equal to beta 1C, from the fiber of maximum compressive strain. Ayun lang sinabi mamaya. Explain ko pa yan. Na? And then the distance from the fiber of maximum compressive strain to the neutral axis shall be measured perpendicular to that axis. Okay? And then the value beta 1 is in accordance with this table. Okay, for FC prime between from 17 to 28 MPa, beta 1 is 0.85. So, okay, from 28 to 55, na between greater than 28 MPa and less than 55 MPa, ito yung formula. But more than 55, 0.65 na. So in other words, kumbaga pwede natin tanggalin to, pwede natin tanggalin na lang tong limit na to. So, pag more than 28 MPa, ito na yung formula mo, pero dapat hindi siya bababa ng 0.65 ang value. Walang unit yung beta. Ha? Walang unit yung beta. So, wag yun ang tanongin saan galing yung beta. Well, that's ginawa na nila yan. May research. So, yun na yun. No? It's a constant relating A and C. Yan ang ating factor beta 1. Well, kasi sa review namin, meron pa rin na gumagamit doon sa beta 1 is equal to 0.85 minus 0.008. No? Okay, may gumagamit pa ba ng ganitong beta sa inyo? Ha? Meron pa bang gumagamit ng ganun? Kaya kung meron pa, that's very old na. No? Ano pa yan? 1991 pa yan. 1991 code pa hanggang 1991. Pagdating ng 2001, wala na yan. Hindi na yan. No? Kaya baka yun pa rin yung ginagamit ninyo. So that's a very old code na. Okay. Alright. So ito yung i-continue natin yung assumption natin. No? So design assumption for non-pre-stressed reinforcement. Right, sige. Sandali ha. Basahin ko lang yung non-pre-stress bars. Okay. Ah, ito. Reinforcement limits. Ah, ito. Sorry ha. Ito. Ito yung gusto kong mabasa. Design properties ng reinforcement. For non-pre-stress bars and wires, the stress below Fy shall be ES times the strain. ES times the strain. Galing kasi yan sa Hooke's law, no? That stress is directly proportional to the strain and the constant of proportionality is the modulus of elasticity. Kaya ito yung ating stress, Fs. Kaya yung stress daw is strain times the modulus of elasticity. And the modulus of elasticity of steel is can be taken, no? Shall be permitted, pinapayagan na to be taken as 200,000 MPa. 200,000 MPa. So sabi dito, if your strain, if the stress below Fy, for stresses below Fy, for Fs below Fy, so ito yung gagamitin natin for the stress, actual stress niya. But for strains greater than that corresponding to Fy, ibig sabihin kapag yung Fs mo is more than Fy na, hindi mo na i-consider the dependency sa strain and it has to be taken equal to Fy. So hanggang Fy ka lang. Kasi pag lumaki na yung Fs more than F, halimbawa yung Fy mo is 415 or 414, ang lumabas na strain mo, such that ang lumabas na Fy mo ay 500 MPa, hindi 500 yung gagamitin mo. But yung Fy lang, 414. Okay, for example lang. Okay? And then, meron din dito. Look at this statement here. For non-pre-stressed beams with very small axial load, kung gawin na lang nating casual conversation na lang, kung yung non-pre-stressed yung beam mo ay napakaliit or halos walang axial load, dapat ang strain at extreme tension fiber shall be at least equal to 0.004. Dito kukunin yung maximum rho, maximum AS. So wag mong damihan yung AS mo na kapag wala siyang axial, halimbawa beam lang, walang axial compression, ilimit natin yung ating strain to 0.004. Okay? So 0.004. Alam naman natin na yung tension control ay 0.005, no? Or less. Okay? Ang compression control naman is Fy yung Fs mo, no? So ayan, 0.004. Dito natin kukunin yung ating rho max mamaya. Diyan natin kukunin yung rho max. Sa dating code kasi, sinabi diyan, ganun pa rin yung statement niya, pero nakalagay doon, way back 2001 code, nakalagay doon na kapag baliit yung axial load ng member mo, dapat ang rho mo hindi lalagpas ng 0.75 of rho balance. That was in the old code. But ito yung one of the major changes doon. Kaya wala na sa code ngayong 2015, even in 2010, wala na yung 0.75 rho balance. Wala na. Ito na yung pumalit. Yan yung pumalit. Strain. Alright? And ito naman yung ating reinforcement limits. Okay? So, reinforcement limit. So, the minimum amount of reinforcement. Sinabi dito, a minimum area of flexural reinforcement shall be provided at every section where tension reinforcement is required. And then the minimum shall be the greater of A and B. Yung malaki sa dalawang yan. Minimum yan. Dati-dati kasi ito lang eh. Ito lang eh. Nah? So we have to check on both. Kung saan yung greater dyan, sinabi dito, ayun ang gagabitin natin. Ito yung maganda sa 2015 na code. Maraming nagtatanong, ano ba kakaiba ng 2010 at 2015? Actually, most elements are the same. Very few, very little. Maliit lang yung diferensya nila. Ang kagandahan din naman ng 2015 na code, mas madaling intindihin. Mas madaling intindihin. Mas hindi na masyado siya pang abogado yung statement niya. No? Ito mga ganito, mostly nga table na yung binibigay niya. Yun ang nagpadali sa kanya. Alright. Now, ano ba yung BW? Ano ba yung B? Alamin natin. Kasi I know, ha? I know, ito based on my experience sa review. Pag sinabi mong, ano ba yung D? Ano ba yung effective debt? Ah, effective debt. Yun na, effective debt. Ano ba yun? Basta effective debt. Yun yung galing sa taas hanggang sa gitna. Ano ba yung effective debt? Sige na. What is effective debt? Diba? Marami doon, ha? Galing doon sa taas ng beam hanggang sa gitna ng ilalim na bar. Merong ganong magsalita. Ano ba yung BW? BW. Basta BW. Alright. Well, if you have that, if you are like that, no, sa review namin, talagang in-stress namin to, do not use the formula. If you cannot define each term in the formula, that's very important. Wala namang definition sa board exam, pero you must be able to define each term. Kasi pag hindi, paano magamit yung formula? No? Paano mo magamit confidently na yun na yun? Yun. Pag hindi mo alam ang meaning ng each term in that formula, tingnan natin. Basahin natin sa code. Well, kung sa code lang tayo, madali kasi meron naman tayong code. Meron dyan sa nomenclature, notations and terminology. Ito yun, no? Ayan. BW. Ano ba yung BW? Tingnan natin. At saka yung B. Ano ba yung B? Tingnan natin dito. Yung D muna. I know most of you knows this already, but marami pa rin balalang. Oh, distance from extreme compression fiber to the centroid of longitudinal. Ano ba yung longitudinal? The bars along the length. Dalawa lang naman yung ating bars, eh. Longitudinal at saka transverse. Yung longitudinal along the length, yun ang tinatawag nating main bar. Yung transverse, yun yung hoops, no? Stirrup, kung sa beam pa, kung sa column ties or spiral, yan, hoop reinforcement siya. So, transverse siya. Bakit transverse? Transverse is perpendicular to the length. No? Normal to the length. We call it transverse. So, yung D natin is the distance from extreme compression fiber to the centroid. No? So, if you have one layer of bar only in the tension part, then madaling ma-locate yung centroid, di ba? Kung isang layer of bar ka lang. Ayan. Halimbawa lang, kung isang layer of bar ka lang. Halimbawa, yung tension natin ay nasa baba. Kung isang layer ka lang, so from extreme compression fiber to the centroid talaga. Eh kung dalawang layers ka na, hanapin mo yung centroid. No? That is not in the middle of the toe. So you can locate the centroid by Varignon Sturen. Yun yung ating effective depth. So from extreme compression fiber, kung ito yung compression fiber mo, eh paano kung halimbawa cantilever beam? Sa cantilever beam, ang compression niya nasa ilalim. So, ang tension niya nasa taas. So, from the bottom to the centroid ng bar na nasa taas. So, we cannot define effective depth as distance from the top to the center. Na? From the extreme compression fiber to the centroid centroid of the tension steel. Yun yung definition niya. Okay? Ano din naman yung BW? Ano naman ngayon ang BW? Tingnan natin, no? So, okay, BW. Ito. Web width, no? Ang web ng ating beam or diameter of circular section. Yung web. So, it did not say tension part, compression part, yung web. Halimbawa, T-beam, yung web. No? Yung ano niya, yung, you know what web is, no? So, pag T siya, eh kung rectangular, walang problema. Wala namang, pare-pareho naman lahat yun. Eh kapag L-shape or T-beam, yung maliit, yung web niya, yung body niya. No? Or kung circular yung, ano mo, yung member mo, like column, spiral, or what, diameter of the column, yun yung BW. So, yung sinasabi ko sa inyo na dapat mong malaman yung definition bago mo, para at least hindi ka magkakamali. Ha? Hindi ka magkakamali. So, magandang basahin nyo. Make it a habit to know all the terms in the formula. Okay, so yan ang ating minimum reinforcement. Yan. Okay lang ba? Okay lang kayo dyan? Ha? So, wala na tayong comment dito. Boring naman ang topic nyo kasi last time may nagbibigay ako, may nagsabi pa. Wag na, if you have nothing good to say, anyway, free naman to. No? Hindi ko naman kayo pinipilit na manood. So, wala lang. Ano lang, accept lang tayo. Be open to any idea. Wag kayo agad mag-comment. No? Kung may idea kang marinig, then ibalansihin mo kung tama ba o hindi. No? Anyway, for our own good naman yun. No? Okay, sige. Ito naman yung tension and compression control. Alright, we will go back to this later on. We'll go back to that. And these are the... Okay, sana daw manalo ng books. Okay, yung iba dyan, hiritay lang yung books. Alright, we will go back to this, no? Ito yung reduction factor natin. Okay, ano ba yung pagkakaiba ng 2010 tsaka 2015? Yung major... yung 2001 pala tsaka yung 2015, ang major talaga niya is itong fee natin, particularly flexure. Dati kasi yung fee natin sa flexure isa lang, point line lang, no? Maging over design ba yan or under design, talagang point line lang, no? Ngayon iba, kapag tension controlled, yes, point line kung tension controlled, okay? Pero kung compression controlled, that will be 0.65. Akong transition siya, ayan. Well, if you will be asking, if you wonder, bakit ganun? Well, in my opinion lang, maganda itong code na to. Kasi, madi-discourage kang mag-over-design. Madi-discourage ka talaga mag-over-design. Kasi kung dadami yung bar mo, magiging transition zone siya or over, liliit yung reduction factor niya. Sorry. Liliit yung reduction factor niya. So, marami yung bars mo, liliit. Kumbaga, kung kukunin mo yung design strength niya, PMN, yung design strength, liliit yung resulta. Kasi alam niya naman na yung requirement naman natin sa strength design, papareho lang naman yan. Halimbawa, sa moment natin, PMN, ganun naman yan, di ba? PMN, MN. Ganun yung ating, we call it criteria. Criterion. Huh? Okay, ang tawag dito is design strength. Galing sa section. Ito naman yung required strength. Ano yung required strength? Galing yan sa load. Dapat yung design strength mo mas malaki, mas mahigit pa or pareho doon sa required strength, yung kinakailangan na strength. That's the basic. Ang tawag diyan criteria. Huwag mong sabihin equation yan o formula. Hindi yung formula, no? Ayan yung criteria mo. Hindi, do not use equal sign. It's wrong to say equal sign. Eh, paano kung hindi equal? Diba? Will it not be safe kung hindi maging equal, correct? So, huwag mong gamitin yung equal sign. Dapat inequality ka. Ah, okay, yung reduction factor natin dito, kapag tension control, 0.9, compression, kung depende doon, halimbawa, it-tied yung ating tied ka other reinforcement dito. 0.9 ang tension control, 0.65 ang compression control. Mamaya, explain pa natin yan ulit. Ano ba yung tension control at saka compression control? Yan yung big difference nung old code at saka sa code na to. Meron din tayong transition. Pero may statement dito na regarding the value of... okay, for the firm reinforcement, no, the strain at the extreme tension, no, shall be Fy over ES. But if you're using grade 280 deformed reinforcement, pwede daw gamitin ang strain equal to 0.002. Pero sa lahat ng pre-stress, dapat yung strain natin at extreme, yung yield strain niya ay taken as 0.002. Anyway, we'll go back to that. Alright, now, let me show to you, interpretin natin yung sinabi ng code. Ah, interpretin natin. Okay, let's consider any section. Any section lang. Ah, okay, kahit anong klaseng section. Meron tayong AS, meron tayong AS prime. Ito yung ating tension steel, yan yung ating compression steel. The section can have any shape. Ito naman yung ating effective depth. From the extreme, kung ito yung compression natin, ito yung extreme compression concrete to the centroid of the tension reinforcement. tawagin natin itong D prime, ah, yung distance, we don't call it cover. Ang examen lang, ang tinatawag niya dyan, effective cover to the bar centroid. Pero yun yung, well, it can be called that way, na D prime. I don't know if the code defined that. Nag-define ba yan ng code? Yung D prime? Tinan na dyan. Ayan, meron pala. Distance from extreme compression fiber to the centroid of longitudinal compression reinforcement. Extreme compression fiber to the centroid of centroid of compression reinforcement. Okay, may definition talaga. Yan. And then let's say ito yung ating neutral axis, NA. Neutral axis natin. Right? So, ang sabi ng code, strain in concrete and non-pre-stressed reinforcement shall be assumed proportional to the distance from the neutral axis. So, proportional. So, ibig sabihin, ito yung ating diagram, strain diagram, proportional, direct proportion. Direct proportion. The reinforcement and concrete, ito yung maximum strain in reinforcement. Okay? Tension steel, ito naman yung sa compression steel, and ito naman yung sa concrete. Ayan, proportional. Yun ang sinabi sa sa section na yan. Pangalawa, maximum strain at extreme concrete compression fiber shall be assumed equal to 0.003. Ayan. By the way, di ko na itanong, okay lang ba yung audio natin? Okay lang ba yung audio natin? Hindi ko pala na itanong sa inyo. Baka mahina. Ha? Okay lang ba? Sana okay lang. Alright. Yes, okay lang. Thank you. So, maximum usable strain is 0.003. Ayan. Alright. Sunod. Tensile strength of concrete shall be neglected in flexural and axial strength calculation. So, yung tensile strength natin. So, kung ito yung NA natin, then ito yung ating tension part, then we will neglect that one. No? Pwede natin i-neglect. Actually, that's a very conservative assumption. Ni-neglect natin. But actually, concrete can carry a certain amount of tensile force. It can. But, you know, it's unreliable. Once it cracks, wala ka nang magawa. Wala kasing fiber yung concrete natin eh. No? Alright. Yan ang sinabi. Okay, next assumption. Okay, equivalent concrete stress tayo. No? So, the equivalent rectangular distribution is in accordance with this section. Sinabi dito, concrete stress of 0.85 Fc prime shall be assumed uniformly distributed over an equivalent compression zone bounded by the edges of the cross-section and a straight line parallel to the neutral axis. So, meron na bounded by the edges and a straight line parallel to the neutral axis. Ganun. Mag-assume tayo ng uniform stress of 0.85 Fc prime over that region. Okay? So, ano ba yung C? Distance from the fiber of maximum compressive strain to the neutral axis C shall be assumed perpendicular to the neutral axis. Ito yung C natin. Perpendicular to the neutral axis. So, ito yung A natin, no? So, sinabi ng code na to na mag-assume daw tayo ng uniform stress of 0.85 bounded by the edges of the cross-section and a straight line. Yun. Yun ang sinabi ng code. Yan yung A natin. And A is beta 1C. Maliwanag ba yan? Ha? Alright. So, ganun na to, no? So, by the way, this is D minus C. Yan. So, yan yung A natin. A is equal to beta 1C. Ito naman yung strain in up ng steel natin. Hello po, good morning po. Okay lang po ba pa-accept kay Benjo Estrada Colon? Ah, ganun ba? O may mga late na nag-requests. Ang dami. Ah, sige lang, tinan natin. Okay, I will okay, sige, pa-accept tayo. Yan. Lagyan nyo ng school, ha? Pag nag-request kayo. Pag walang school, hindi ko, binabasa ko na yung school. Sana, kasi baka mapasok tayo dito ng mga iyong panatong samukan ba? Yan. Okay, so ayan. Okay, sige, na-accept ko na lahat. May nag-accept kami, kaya lang hindi yata mahabol. Okay, sige, sige. Ito na, beta 1C. So ito yung strain ng ating strain natin, no? FS over ES. Alright, so let's derive a formula for the stress in tension and compression steel. So let's derive this one from the strain diagram, na? From this strain diagram, we have by proportion tayo, similar triangle, na? This is to this, na? This is to D minus C as this is to C. Correct. That's very clear. Then we have here the first formula na na-derive natin. Na? Ito yung formula in computing the stress in any tension bar, tension steel. Na? So, yung ating Fs is 600 times D minus C over C. Yung D natin dyan is the distance from the extreme compression fiber to the centroid of the tension bar. Yan ang ating first formula. So kahit anong shape ng ating beam, kahit doubly or singly reinforced, pwedeng magamit yan. Any shape of the beam, pwedeng magamit yan. Okay? And another, if we derive the stress in the compression bar, that is Fs prime over Es, no? Yung strain niya. So again, by proportion, this is to C minus D prime as 0.003 is to D. Alright, so we have another formula. Ito naman yung formula in computing the tension, or I mean, stress of the compression bar. 600 times, okay, look at the similarities. Pareho lang, naiba lang sa numerator. Dito D minus C, dito naman C minus D prime. Ito. C minus D prime. Okay. So, makinig kayo sa derivation. I know, sasabihin ng iba, wala namang derivation sa board. Yes, I know. Pero you know what? Kung undergraduate pa kayo, huwag muna kayo magiging board-oriented. Masama. Hindi rin maganda. Principle muna tayo. Para, well, I know, habol din natin sa board. Pero sana masiparate natin yung dalawa. Masiparate natin yung dalawa, no? Para, kasi yung board kasi minsan, lalo na sa design, depende sa examiner eh. Kung ano lang yung tinatanong, eh, in actual job naman, hindi naman yan depende sa examiner. No? Okay, sige, ituloy natin. Next, ito na yung ating uniform. Ito yung ating compression block. Yan, rectangular, equivalent. If you draw the side view, ito yun. Yan. So, 0.85 FC5, ito yung 3D niya. Na? So, the forces acting on this diagram, we have the tension in steel. Okay, let's have it ASFS. Huwag muna FY. Generic lang muna tayo. ASFS to be general. And then the compressive force in concrete. Tawa, sabihin natin C sub C. C sub C lang. Subscript ko si... I know, mayroong ibang meaning yun eh. Yung C sub C sa code. May ibang meaning siya. Tingnan natin. Hindi. Small letter. Clear cover of reinforcement. C sub C. Small letter. Capital letter yung C sub C ko. Ako, minsan ingat din ako sa ko sa ano eh, para hindi tayo maging kapare-pare lahat ng ating mga notations. Okay. The compressive force in concrete is what? That will be the stress 0.85 FC prime times, baka sabihin nyo 0.85 FC prime times BD. AB. Hindi ha. 0.85 FC prime multiplied by the area of this compression block. Tawagin na natin A sub C. The area of compression concrete. So, general. Kasi hindi naman lahat ng beam. Although, majority of the sections are rectangular. But not all rectangular. We have to accept that. May triangular, may trapezoidal, di ba? Pwede din. Na? Pero I know, bihira. Kadalasan talaga rectangular. And then, the compressive force in our compression steel. Ayan. Tawagin natin CSC. That will be equal to AS prime, the area, AS prime times FS prime. FS prime yung stress of the compression steel. Yan, yung ating forces. Yan. So, that's what the code gives us. Lateral equilibrium shall be maintained. Sa measure of process 0 and moment about any point 0. So, that is our fundamental talaga. Okay? Yan. Okay? And ito yung design properties na sinabi, binasa natin kanina na regarding our FS, no? For FS below FY, FS shall be taken as ES times the steel strain. For stress below FY, no? The stress is equal to ES times the strain. But for stress above FY, we will take it equal to FY. Alright? Ibig sabihin, for FS less than FY, ito yung ating stress in tension steel. But for FS more than FY, ito yung tinatawag nating steel does not yield. Over design. Na? Ito naman yung steel yields. Okay? So, if your FS is more than FY, then we will use FS equals FY. That's according to this provision. Na? Yan. Okay ba? Okay lang? Ha? Okay lang? Nakaka-gets ba kayo? Or you know this already? Maybe, no? Ito na yung diniscuss ninyo. Nalaman yan, sir. Kasi pag dumiretso lang kayo sa formula, talagang mahihirapan kayo. At tandaan niya yan. Madali pag dumiretso ka ng formula. No? Ako may explanation ako dyan eh. Bakit yung mga students, formula na lang. Ayun yung epekto ng cramming. Yung pag hindi ka nag-aaral, no? Mag-aaral ka lang pag-exam na, yung talaga magka-cram ka. Ang tendency doon, wala ka lang time mag-understand ng principle. No? You will result into memorizing formulas. And that's what we hate sa review. Pinabalik-balik namin yan. Ako, pag formula-oriented ka, walang katapusang tanong ang gagawin mo. Kasi wala ka eh. Depending ka sa situation eh. Para bang kung ano yung situation doon sa problem na yun, yun na lang yung inaharap mo, wala. Pag binago yung tinist yung problem, hindi mo na masasagot kasi kulang ka sa principle. Kaya ito, principle tayo. Okay. Next. Let's derive the formula kung rectangular ang beam and then ang steel na yield. Alright? Singly reinforced rectangular beam. I know you ever wondered, sir, meron bang singly reinforced? Meron bang beam na walang compression bar? Actually, meron. Yung mga shallow na mga beams, like halimbawa slab. Slab is a beam. Shallow masyado siya. No? 150 mm yung total depth niya. Hindi mo, pag dinesign mo yan as doble, sayang lang yung bar mo. No? Okay? So, sayang lang yung bar mo kapag tawag dyan. Kapag ginawa mo siyang doble. No? Even some footings, singly yan. Walls. Alright. So, maraming singly actually. But sa beam, alam naman natin na meron tayong top and bottom bar. Eh, saan mo ibibita yung ano mo? Yung compression, yung stirrup mo, di ba? Pero kahit na meron siyang top bar or compression bar, pwede nating i-neglect. Pwede nating i-neglect yun. No? Depende kasi may mga times kasi pa, kahit i-neglect mo man siya or hindi, lost the same na yung result. But anyway, so ito, i-derive natin ha. Singly reinforced rectangular beam, steel yields. Steel yields. Na pag sinabi mong steel yields, hindi ibig sabihin na tension control yan ha. Ang tension control kasi, yung strain niya, 0.005 strain. Lang tension control, 0.005. That's corresponding to a stress of 1,000 MPa. Bakit 1,000? Kasi 0.005 times FY, times E na 200,000. Yan ang corresponding sa stress na 1,000 MPa. If you are using 200,000 MPa na E, 1,000 yan. Na? So in other words, kung kahit lang more than yung halimbawa, yung FY mo is 414. So kahit na 500 siya, yes, still yields. But hindi sa tension control. Transition siya. Okay? Alright, yeah. So let's apply equilibrium. Ito yung forces natin, ha? Ito yung compressive force in concrete and the tensile force in steel. So summation of process horizontal equals zero. The compressive force in concrete equals the tension in steel. So the compressive force in concrete I that one equals ASFY. Alright? Okay, so if you solve for A, ito yung lalabas na A. ASFY divided by 0.85 FC prime B. Ayan. Initialize lang natin yung A. Or, okay, we can multiply and divide that by D. If we multiply and divide that formula by D, and D is a non-zero number, so pwede, no? And D over D is 1, kaya it doesn't change anything. It does not change anything. So we can rewrite that expression as ganito. ASFY over ganon. Alright, here we have a dimensionless ratio, AS over BD. Huh? So let's call it rho. And we call it the reinforcement ratio, AS over BD. So if we put that, or if we call it rho, then this formula becomes like this. Rho FYB over 0.85 FC prime. Tama ba? Another, if we assign this to a single variable, say omega. Okay? Alright. Rho FY over FC prime. Let's call it omega. Omega. Then the formula for A can be reduced to ganito na lang. Omega D over 0.85. Omega D. So yung omega, kung titina mo, wala naman yun sa code. Wala sa code yung omega. Wala sa code yung omega. Yung rho pa meron, no? Ay yung rho. Pero yung omega, wala yan sa code. Okay? So, sinisimplify lang natin. Okay, now, finally, let's now compute the moment. Okay, the nominal strength of the section, MN. So, MN can be CC times the moment arm, or di kaya T times the moment arm. Either of the two is okay. Why? Kasi in the first place, equal nga yung dalawa eh. Di ba? Equal naman yung CC. So, you can take the moment by taking moment about this, or by taking moment about that. Ah, so yan yung ating nominal strength. We call it nominal strength. Ah, so what is C sub C? Ito yung ating C sub C. Oh. Alright. And what is A? What is A? Ito yung A natin. Ilagay natin dyan. Ah, ito yung magiging resulta niya. Ah, so the 0.85 will cancel out. Ilabas natin yung... Okay. And then, ayan. Kakancel yung 0.85. And then, kung ilabas natin yung D, magiging ganito yung ating formula. Look. I know that's becoming familiar to you. Huh? FC prime omega BD squared times the quantity 1 minus 0.59 omega. Diba? Alright. And further, if we assign this expressions to a single term, let's call it Rn. No? Huh? Rn, then the formula for the nominal strength can be written as Rn BD squared. We call it nominal strength of the section. And the design strength is phi mn. The design strength ay phi mn. So phi times Rn BD squared. Diba? I know you're very familiar with these formulas. Diyan galing yan. So take note, ha? Kailan pwedeng gamitin yan? Rectangular yung beam, walang compression bar, and then yung steel natin nag-yield. Kahit na hindi siya tension control, basta yield yung ating tension steel, pwedeng gamitin yan. Na? So yan, yung phi mo dyan is between 0.65 to 0.9 yan. Hindi dapat siyang, ano, pag compression control kasi, hindi pwede to. Pag hindi mag-yield yung ating steel, you cannot use this formulas. Alright. And of course, the criterion for strength is ito. Ito yung criterion natin. The design strength must be greater than or equal to the required strength. Okay, may topic na. Ano pag ibig sabihin kapag sinasabing nominal strength? Nominal. Nominal strength. Ah, tanungin natin si ano. Nominal lang yung based lang doon sa section. Nominal lang. Nominal strength of the section. So, the nominal is coming from the section strength. Nominal shear, based lang doon sa mga assumptions sa code. No? Ba, nominal shear strength ng section. No? Yung 0.17 square root of FC prime BWD. Nominal lang. Yung design, i-multiply natin ng reduction factor. Let's try AI. I-try natin si ano. I know you are ano na rin kayo sa AI. Sige, AI natin. Nominal. Meron ako ditong account. Nominal strength. Pero dito, malaking gamit to kung alam mo na rin yung principle, no? Master Repair. Kasi kung hindi mo rin alam, siya AI, huwag kayo masyadong mag-rely. Baka, siyempre, it's just getting information from the internet. Eh, baka mali yung nakuha niya. Pwede yung i-re-ask and re-ask, no? Kasi marami siyang itatanong eh. Marami siyang nagbabari yung sasagot niya. Tingnan natin, ano ba sinabi niya? Nominal strength refers to the expected strength of concrete based on materials and proportions used in its construction. Theoretical value of strength is used. Okay, nominal strength. Yung nominal lang. Yung strength ng section based on the assumptions, no? Na ginamit natin. Yan, nominal. Nominal strength. Alright. So, thank you for asking. Baka may tanong pa kayo. Okay. Tanong-tanong kayo. Okay lang magtanong. Eh? Nominal lang. Based on the sec. Okay. Yan. Ang tawag dito, design. Pag sinabi mo ng PMN, ang tawag dyan, design. Or it can be called ultimate. Ultimate strength. Ultimate strength. Or design strength. Pero yung MU, wag yung sabihin ultimate. Walang, okay, there's no such thing as ultimate load. Marami kasing, ano ba yung ultimate moment niyan? That's, parang sumasabog yung tainga ko pag narinig ko yung word na yung ultimate moment. You cannot say ultimate load eh. Ultimate moment. Ultimate moment capacity pwede pa. Ultimate capacity is okay. No? Pero pag sinabi mo ultimate load, parang sasabog yung mukha. Sasabog yung tainga ko. Parang ano ultimate load? Pinakamalaking load? Ilagay mo lahat ng mundo dyan. Ilagay mo na dyan. Ultimate capacity. Meron yun. Ultimate load? Wala. Parang kulang, di ba? Si ultimate load, ha? Ultimate, factored load siguro. Factored load. Ultimate strength. Pinakamalaking kaya niya, no? Pag mo sabihin, what is the ultimate load? Pinakamalaking load, di ba? Pinakamalaking load na kaya, hindi yun ultimate load. Ultimate capacity, di ba? So, yan yun. Ang required strength po ba based from the loads? Yes. Ang required strength MU, galing yan sa mga load. Gagamitan mo ng load factor. No, 1.2 for the dead, 1.6 for the light, galing yan sa loads. No, the required. Kumbaga, kung ang kinakailangan ay 1,000 kN, dapat yung design strength ng section mo must be equal or more than that. Di ba? Yun yung logic doon. Yun yung tawag natin criteria. No? For it to be called safe, dapat yung kakaya niya must be malaki kaysa doon sa kinakailangan. Yun ang tinatawag natin required strength. Kahit sa code, ang nasa code dyan, required strength. Let me look for it, ha? Meron ditong... dali. Required strength. Okay, ano to? 63. Page 63. Ano bang statement ng code? Required strength. Ito yung mga the required strength can be calculated with the factored load combination of section 4 or 5. So the required strength shall be calculated in accordance with the factored load combination. So the required strength MU, yung UU na yun, galing yun doon sa factored load combination. Yan, yun yung U. Section 4 or 5, ha, tinan natin. 405. Ayan. Okay? Oh, the required strength U. Oh, look. The required strength U shall be at least equal to the effects of the factored load according to the table. Yan. Required strength. So, yung required strength galing doon sa, ang tawag naman sa DL, service loads. Service loads. Service dead load. Yung service dead load, yun yung actual. Actual. Service live load, yung actual talaga. Walang dagdag. Yung factored, minultiply na natin ng mga load factors depende sa combination mo. Is that clear? Maliwanag ba? Ha? So we have to define this clearly para hindi tayo maano. Kaya lang, malungkot lang sa exam kasi, yung examiner natin ngayon, ginagamit niya pa rin yung term na ultimate. the Lord's at ultimate condition. Sa bagay, may sense din naman kunti, pero dapat hindi na gamitin yun eh. Sabihin, the factored load siguro, ultimate condition. Pwede naman, ultimate condition kasi pinapactor natin yung load. No? Ang masama, pag sinabi mong ultimate loads, parang hindi siya bagay, ultimate capacity. No? Suggest ko lang naman yun, kung contract kayo doon, then ako lang naman, ha? Base lang tayo doon sa principle, hindi naman base sabi ng iba. Dono? Okay. Alright, sige. And another formula that will come out, if you will solve omega, notice here, if you solve omega here using quadratic equation yan eh, and then yung omega mo ay gawin mong ganito, then you can derive this. Hindi ko na ini-derive. Ito yung mahabang formula ng rho. Ito yung mahabang formula ng rho. 0.35 FC prime over FY times the quantity. Yan. So again, these formulas are only valid if, number one, rectangular yung ating compression concrete and tension steel yields. Walang compression bar. Tension steel yields. Otherwise, these formulas cannot be. Halwa, doble. Hindi pwedeng gamitin yan. Kasi kung doble, but you may ask me, but hindi pwede siya? Oh, you cannot start with this. You cannot start with that kung doble siya. And kung hindi rectangular yung compression block mo, then you cannot use this A times B. Correct? You cannot use that A times B kung hindi rectangular yung block mo. Kaya, kung alam mo saan galing yung formula, alam mo paano gamitin. Yun yung importante sa mga mag-memorize ka ng formula. Tignan nyo kung saan galing, hanggat maaari, no? Alamin nyo saan galing. Alright, balance condition. Ano naman yung ating balance condition? A balance condition is attained when yung stress in concrete and steel sabay na attain. Meaning the stress in steel is Fy over ES. At the same time, the concrete has reached its ultimate strain of 0.003. So from this diagram, ito yung ating magiging figure ng strain. Then ito, C balance ang tawagin natin is to that. And then if you move this here, magiging gano'n yan, no? So, kumbaga, minove ko lang yung aking line na yan. Minove ko lang dito. Tinan nyo. Paano ko ginawa? Okay, tinan nyo. Minove ko lang. Ganun. Kaya, this one is 0.003 plus that. Okay? So, by proportion, similar triangle, this is to this as this is to that. Ito na. Diba? Okay, if you solve for C balance and this is 200,000, ito man yung ating E, no, modulus of elasticity, although you can, it is permitted to use that, but if you can specify talaga yan sa code, then wag 200,000 ang, I mean, sa exam, wag 200,000 gamitin mo. Kung naka-specify yan, let's say 205,000 yan dapat, 210,000, then yun ang gamitin mo. Otherwise, we are allowed or we are permitted to use that value. Alright, yan. Solving for CB, ito yung lalabas. Alright, class, this is actually the general formula. General formula yan. No? Kahit may compression bar yan, kahit column pa yan, kahit anong shape ng ating beam. By the way, this formula is independent with the shape of the section. Because we only use that or derive that based on the strain. The strain diagram is independent with the shape of the beam. Kahit anong shape ng beam mo, circular man yan, rectangular man yan, triangular man yan, the strain diagram doesn't matter. Yan pa rin yan. And since this is based on the strain diagram, then that can be used sa kahit anong klaseng section. So how do we apply or use the C balance? Okay, if you remember the formula kanina na dinerive natin, I don't know kung na-remember nyo to kanina, no? Nag-derive tayo niyan, saan ba yung banda? Dito yun, no? Ito. Ito yun. FS. Ayan. Okay? Another way to derive this formula is to use this formula with FS equals FY. Madi-derive mo itong formula yan. So, either of these two can be used. Pwede yan, pwede din to. Ito yung kanina natin dinerive. Ginamit ko lang na FS ay FY. Ito yun, no? Pag ginamit mo dito FY, balance yan. Yan yung balance C. Balanced C. Alright, I hope nakuha ninyo. Na? Now, how about yung rectangular yung section natin? What will happen to the formula if our section is rectangular? Tingnan natin. So, look, na-derive na natin to kanina. Na-derive na natin ito kanina. Diba? Na-derive natin to kanina. Dito yan, no? A. Ito yun, no? A equals rho FYD over 0.85 FC prime. Okay, let's use that one. Alright? Okay, if we write that in terms of C, we know A equals beta 1 C. So, A, C is equal to A over beta 1. So, A over beta 1 because C is equal to beta 1. A is equal to beta 1 times C. So, C is equal to A over beta 1. Yan na yan. Alright? So, if we equate the C balance, ito yung C balance natin, if we compare these two, and that is equal to that, okay? Then, solving for rho, ito yung formula ng balance tilt ratio. I know you're very familiar with that formula. 0.85 FC prime beta 1 times 600 all over FY over 600 plus FY. So, here in this formula, ang ginamit natin na E200,000. Bakit naging 600 yan? Kasi that's 200,000 times 0.003. Kasi pag hindi 200,000 yan, iba yung value niyan. Iba yung value niyan, hindi 600. Ano ba? Pag in-specify sa... Here, example lang, for example, specify ng examiner, use E of 210,000. You cannot use the 600. So, 210,000 times 0.003, that will be the value. So, dapat alam mo saan galing yon para hindi ka ma-technical. Dali ha. Ano ba yung magiging value niya? Gagamit tayo ng MATCAD. MATCAD para mabilis. Yung ginagamit namin sa lecture. Although, nagkakalcute din kami. Kaya lang 210 times 0.003. So, that will be your... Hindi 600. 630. Just in case. Just in case. Alright? Pero again, ha, magagamit mo lang to kapag rectangular ang beam. Non-rectangular beam, do not use that. Do not use that. Dito ka. Pwede yan kahit anong klaseng beam. Kahit anong klaseng beam, pwede yan. Independent yan kung anong shape ng beam. But ito, very dependent. Dapat rectangular yung ating compression block. Compression concrete. Rectangular. Okay lang ba? Ha? Okay lang ba dyan? Sige. Para ma-break yung, baka na-board na yung iba. Na, raffle muna tayo. Na, raffle muna tayo para, okay. Sandali. Hindi yan yung i-open ko. Sana yun. Mag-raffle tayo. Saan ka dito hanap? May pre-lecture ka na. May raffle pa. Ha? So, ang gagawin ko ngayon, there are 430. Ang dami na nag-sign up. No? Okay, 430 na yung nag-sign up. So, this will generate a random number. And then, kung ano yung mag-generate niya, yun ang ilalagay ko, ha? Okay, maglalagay muna ako ng 000 para makapag-generate siya ng bagong number. Alright, 336. Okay, so this is 50% discount sa aming online review under pressure. Well, instead of 20,000 yung base price, 10,000 na lang. Online review under pressure. Number 336. Who is the lucky winner? And you are? Halpone Mary Hyacin. Tagawit. Halpone. So please, okay, message me here. Halpone, nakikita ko na yung pangalan mo dito sa monitor ko. Nakikita ko na yung pangalan mo. So, you must message, send me a message. Eh? Sige. Halpone. Pag hindi mag-message in account of hindi na ako tatawag. Na hindi na. Alright. Bila ako ng 10. 1. 10 seconds. We will generate another number. Halpone. Wala yata. Alright. Wala, wala. So, she's not watching. Sorry ha. Dapat nagme-message kasi makikita ko naman yung message nyo dito. Meron akong monitor. Meron akong monitor dito. So, okay. So, wala siya. Okay, another. Mag-generate naman tayo ng ibang number. So, sorry for that. So, wala na ha. Okay, 392. 392. Okay, si ITU. Dumdum Mary Grace. Pero kung nanalo na kayo before, ah, wag na ha. Isenten na. Ano na? Ah, Dumdum Mary Grace. Dumdum. Ah, by the way, please monitor your timestamp. Meron tayong timestamp dito diyan sa monitor ninyo. If you think that late na masyado yung timestamp ninyo doon sa time, doon sa anak, yellow pala yung ano ko. Hindi makita. Sorry. Pag nakita nyo, medyo late na yung time, pinilitan ko ng kulay. Ayan, makikita yung timestamp sa ilalim. Eh. Hindi. Oh, kita nyo yung timestamp. No? Somewhere dito sa baba. No? Yung timestamp na yan. 10:08. Oh, Mary Grace Dumdum. Alright, sige. Mary Grace Dumdum, CITU, 50% discount. Ito, nag-message na siya. Nag-message na si Mary Grace Dumdum. Okay, congratulations, no? 50%. Yan. Sa online review and refresher. Alam nyo, yung review kasi namin ngayon, meron pa rin kaming pure online, meron kaming hybrid, no? So, and 3 times a day na face-to-face, 3 times a day at sorry 3 times a week na face to face MWF, meron din TTHS, meron din kaming online, may ano siya blend, ano siya hybrid na. So yun, Mary Grace Dumdum. So yun yung aming review ngayon. Okay, so okay, another lucky winner, dalawang free books, number 117. Oy, ito wala 95. Nag-chase agad. 95. Go. Oh, Ipso, Tanawan Campus, Inderio Joseph. Parang pamilya na ako sa pangalan. Inderio Joseph Jr. Are you watching? Inderio Joseph. Ipso, Tanawan. Oh, nagkikita ka ba yan na? Ah? Ah, nagbawaray ako. Ah? Kung nagkikita ka, pag-missis na yun. Okay? So, yan. Madali ma-experto. Ilan na? Inderio, nakikita ko na yung pan. Hi sir, bago pong libro sa may bago, wala pa. Hindi ko kaya nang magsulat lang ano, ang busy, para busy na rin sa review. Sige lang. Inderio Joseph. Inderio Joseph. Ha? Wala, wala. Alright. Wala. Okay, so let's have another lucky winner. Sorry, Mr. Inderio. Pag nakalampas na, wala na tayong magawa, ha? Okay, next. 107. Oh, Visayas State University. BSU. Bye-bye yata to. Panya Rod Anthony. Panya Rod Anthony. Nako, tatagal tayo pag daming na-fill up kasi. Ha? Panya Rod Anthony. Ayun, nanood. Si Panya Rod Anthony. Present. Congratulations. Sige, mamaya naman yung iba para hindi kayo umalis. Eh baka pag tapos yung raffle, alis na kayo lahat. Okay, congrats sa mga winner. So we have here our balance steal ratio. Ah, okay. So next, the maximum steal ratio. Maximum, hindi na 0.75 pro balance. According to the code, for non-pistress beams with very small amount or wala talagang axial load, yung axial load niya, kumbaga yung factored axial load niya ay less than 0.1 FC prime AG. No? 0.1 FC prime AG. No? The strain at extreme tension fiber shall be at least equal to 0.004. Dapat hindi lalaki. At least equal to. So, yun yung pinakamaliit. No? So, yeah. Then, if we will apply proportion, this is to this as the... Okay. This is to this as D is to that. This will become 0.007, di ba? Kasi 0.003 yan, di ba? And then this is 0.004. That is according to the code. Then, ito yung lalabas. No? C max is to 0.003 as D is to 0.007. Bakit C max? Bakit C max? Bakit hindi C minimum? Kasi pag lumaki yung C mo, liliit yung strain niya. Liliit yung strain. pag lumaki yung C natin, liliit yung strain ng tension steel. So, hindi na siya magiging po yung chair 4. Sinabi nito, at least, eh, hindi shall be less than, no? Shall be at least equal to, no? So, dapat equal or greater. Alright, if you solve for C max, yan ang lalabas. 3/7 of D. 3/7 of D. Now, if we apply that to the single reinforced rectangular beam na na-derive natin kanina, diba? If you set this to 3/7 of D, no? Alright, makukuha natin yung rho. Yan yung pinaka-rho max ngayon. Yan yung pinaka-rho max natin. 3/7 of, yan. Hindi na 0.75 FC prime. Hindi na siya 0.75 FC prime. Ah, sorry, 0.75 pro balas. Is that clear? No? Saan galing yung 3/7? Galing yan sa code. Because galing din yan dito sa strain diagram. But naging ganun yan, dinerive natin to kanina. Dinerive natin kanina. 3/7. Alright. Yan ang ating maximum. Another row that you need to compute using the 2015 NSCP is the maximum steel area na tension controlled siya. Maximum tension steel for tension controlled na member. Maximum tension steel na walang, hindi mo kailangan ng compression bar, no? Okay, according to the code kasi, ang strain natin sa tension control is at least 0.005. At least 0.005. No? So, greater, less than, okay? Dapat, mas maliit pa sa 0.005. Shall not exceed. No? 0.005 na value. 0.006, at least pala, not greater, at least. So pag lumaki pa yung strain, no, lumaki pa, mas maganda pa pag lumaki yan. Okay, tingnan niyo yung relationship ng strain tsaka yung value ng C. The smaller the C, the bigger yung ating tension strain, no? Kaya yun ano yun sila, contrast. Pag lumaki yung C, liliit yung strain ng steel, liliit yung stress. So, magiging dangerous yun. Magiging over-reinforced siya. Alright, 0.005. So, yan ang gamitin natin. Then, by proportion again, no? So, this is to that, or this is to this, as D is to 0.008. So, in similar manner kanina, pagkuha ng ating value ng rho, no? If we set this to 3/8 of D, then ito yung lalabas na formula. Ito yung rho, maximum rho na tension controlled siya. Very important yan sa analysis. At least alam mo na pwede siya maging tension controlled kahit singly reinforced. Kasi beyond that, dapat mo na siyang gawing doubly reinforced. If you want your section to be tension controlled, dapat yung yung singly reinforced, halimbawa, singly reinforced, okay, dapat yung rho mo ay hindi lalaki dyan. Yan yung rho T natin. Tension control. Okay? Yan. And ito naman yung ating minimum reinforcement. Yan. So, okay, binasa ko na to kanina. Para hindi ninyo nasulbin tong dalawa actually. Sinabi kasi dito, the minimum is the greater of these two. No? And based on these formulas, this will only govern, this expression A will only govern if your FS, FC prime ay more than or equal to that. Galing yan dyan, maderive, kaya mong maderive yan. Equate mo tong dalawa. Equate mo yung dalawang yan. Makukuha mo yung value ng FC prime na ito yung mag-govern. So in other words, if your FC prime is less than this value, automatic, ito yung gawin mong AS mean. Or pwede ka rin mag-row. Row. Pero take note, that may not be very comparable with rho kasi BW yan eh, hindi yan B. BW, no? The width of the web. Yan ang ating formulas. Okay, So, malapit na tayo mag-example. Malapit na tayo mag-example. So, let me give you what the scenario on what will happen if you investigate a singly reinforced beam. Tingnan nyo ha. Scenario lang. Gagawa tayo dito ng parang tawag dyan. Parang diagram or hindi naman flowchart. Okay? Oh, by the way, okay lang ba? Okay lang ba kayo dyan? Ha? May natutunan ba kayo? Ha? Okay lang kayo dyan, mga kapuso? Okay? Anong oras na ba? 10:18 na. So, 1 hour ba higit na tayo? Okay lang? Ha? Okay lang kayo? Yes po. Ha? Okay, okay. So, sige. Tuloy tayo. Yes po. Heart, heart, heart. Yan. Sige. Ito yun, oh. Analysis or investigation. Yung analysis or investigation, pareho lang yan. Kumbaga, meron kang section, analyze mo yung capacity niya. Ano yung kaya niya? Damo, ira na baruan. Oh, thank you. I would appreciate that. I would appreciate kung marami kayo natutunan. Yan ang maganda. Oh, kahit saan man kayo mag-review after this, kayo naman ang mapipili din. Wala. Huwag nyo sabihin, ito, maganda to kasi ito. Depende talaga yan. Well, recommendations will work, of course, no? Pero nasa sa inyo yan. Nasa sa inyo talaga yan. Huwag yung sisihin yung review center, no? Don't stop blaming others for your demise, no? Nasa sa inyo yan. Nasa sa inyo talaga. Ito, part lang to ng aming presentation. Part lang ito ng aming lecture. Para to show you what's our style. Actually, ito yung style ng aming review. Ang live namin is via Facebook. Kaya ito ang ginagawa natin ngayon. Ang replay niyan, nasa website namin. Meron kaming website. Meron maraming ano doon. Nandun, meron kayong sariling dashboard. Makikita niyo yung activities, what to do. We are using Moodle, if you are familiar. Some of you, I know, some schools are using that. Moodle ang ginagamit namin. May sarili talaga kaming dashboard. Sarili kayong dashboard. Nandun yung records ninyo lahat. No, yung mga payment ninyo, doon nyo nagagawin, no? Yung mga lecture, assignments, exams, nandoon lahat. Nandoon lahat. Pati mga other references, nandoon. Ipapakita ko mamaya yung other features of our website. Okay, bago yan, ito muna. Analysis. Okay? Let's say we have a rectangular beam. Given lahat ng ano, beam data, hinahanap ang strength. Inahanap ang strength given lahat ng data. Ito naman yung customary shop, ito naman yung common eh. Ha? So, what will happen here? So, given ang AS. Okay, ito yung mangyayari dyan. May dimension ka na, no na yung dimension. Kapag napakaliit, napakakunti ng AS mo, what will happen? Single reinforced tayo. Kapag napakakunti ng AS, natural, the neutral axis will be malayo sa center. Eh, sandali. Dali ha. Eh na. Napindot ko yung nagbago yung ano na ano ko. Okay. Di ba? Kung napakakunti ng AS mo, then yung C mo maliit. Maliit yung C mo. Kapag maliit yung C mo, you know, napakalaki ng strain kasi yung magiging strain diagram niya ganito. Imagine niyo 0.003. Ito ang strain ng steel. Malaki masyado yan. So, sigurado, tension steel yields. No? Yung C mo dyan is more than 3/8 of D. Sigurado yan. What is 3/8 of D? 3/8, almost 1/2 yan. 0.375 yata yung 3/8. No? 0.375 ba yung 3/8? 3/8. 0.375. No? So, sigurado yan. Siguradong steel yields yan. Siguradong steel yields yan. Kung napakaliit ng steel ba, yan yung strain diagram mo. So, sigurado talaga, more than 0.005 yan. That's tension control. The stress of that is more than 1,000 MPa. Kaya yung ating strength yan ay TMN. Ito yung ating design strength. Na? Yan, TMN. Yung P mo dito, sigurado 0.9 yan. Applicable yung formula. Magagamit nyo yung derived natin kanina. No? Applicable siya. And then your P will be 0.9. This is tension control. So, umbaga, maliit yung AS mo. So, what will happen kung dagdagan natin yung AS? Dagdagan natin yung steel area. Tingnan nyo, what will happen? Na? Yan. Ah, by the way, before going to that, make sure din na yung AS mo dito is more than AS mean. nag-iimbestigate ka, kumbaga meron ka ng still area. Binigay na yun, para mag-isipin nyo lang, may lumapit sa iyo. Sabi, engineer, paki-check na itong beam ko, nagawa na ito eh, gawa na ito, or ito na yung design ko, ito yung nilagay kong bar, okay ba yan? Ano ba yung strength niya? Na? So, you have to check na yung A na binigay niya is more than roaming, ESB. Otherwise, sabihin mo dun sa ano mo, sabihin mo dun sa nagpa-check sa'yo, nako pare, yung ano mo, yung design mo, yung seal area mo, dagdagan mo kung hindi po managawa. Kasi kung hindi mo dadagan yun, below the minimum yun. Eh kung paano kung gawa na? Tapos na, wala ka na magawa. Kung paano sabihin, dagdagan mo. Sirain mo yan. Baguhin mo. Diba? I have to check on that. Alright? So, yung kumbaga, kung if the AS is, ano ba, board exam yan, board exam. Na? So, huwag mong dagdagan. If your AS is less than roaming, huwag mong dagdagan. Kasi pinapa-investigate ka lang eh. Hindi ka naman pinapa-design. At least you know what you're doing. So you stop. Kasi you cannot evaluate that. It's below the minimum requirement. If that will happen. Ano ba? For example, dalawang 20mm lang. O what is the strength? And then yung AS mo is less than roaming. Huwag mong sabihin use roaming. No. You are not designing. You are just investigating. Wala kang karapatang magdagdag. Wala kang karapatang magdagdag ng bar. Kaya, you stop. MN cannot be evaluated. Alright? Okay, next. Dumami. Okay, look. Dinagdagan natin ng bar. Okay? So, okay. You continue. For as long as the raw is less than roti, pwede. You can still use the formula and it is still tension control. Kumbaga yung AS mo is less than the AS na tension control siya, you continue, okay, we can use the formula. Eh, paano kung dumami pa yung bar? No? Alright, dumami pa yung bar. Well, okay, basta yung raw mo hindi pa lalabas ng roti, you can still use the formula and it is still tension control. Hanggang raw na equal to roti, ito yung roti. Tension control, singly reinforced. Alright. So, tension control pa rin siya. Hanggang raw equal to roti. Kumbaga dito, pag nag-equal na siya, yung strain ng steel mo is just equal to 0.005. Na? Equal to 0.005 yung ating stress. And then yung FS mo is exactly equal to 1,000 MPa. Alright. Now, what will happen kapag dumami pa yung bar mo? Ha? Again, nag-i-investigate tayo. Ha? Hindi tayo nag-design. Nag-i-investigate tayo. Na? Pag dumami pa yung bar mo, yun. Alright. Okay. So, more than roti na. Well, for as long as the FS is more than FY, pwede mo pang gamitin yung formula. Because it is still, tawag dyan, still yields pa rin. Pwede gamitin. Kaya lang, yung P natin, hindi na siya 0.9. Transition zone na siya. Value of FS mo is less than 1,000 MPa, but more than FY. No? But more than FY. Nasa transition zone siya. Hindi na 0.9 yung Phi mo. Pero the formula in solving for MN is the same. Hindi nga lang 0.9 yung Phi mo. Okay? Now, kapag dumami pa yung bar mo. Ha? Dumami pa ng dumami yung bar. Alright. Okay, halimbawa lang. It so happened that balance. Okay, balance siya. Pwede. Your FS is equal to FY. Balance na to ngayon. Sabay na mag-yield ang steel tsaka yung concrete. Diba? Pwede mo pa rin gamitin yung formula. Now, balance na to, yung room, yung fee mo, hindi na point na, hindi na transition. Ano na? Compression control na yan. 0.65 na. 0.65 na yung ating reduction factor. Nasa code yan. Hindi ko lang kanina masyado binasa kasi medyo malayo pa saan ba yun. Ito yun, no? Compression controlled strain is a net tensile strain at balanced strain condition. Na? Compression controlled section is a cross section in which the net tensile strain in the extreme tension reinforcement at nominal strength is less than or equal to the compression controlled strain limit. And the compression controlled strain limit is at balanced condition. Ang tension controlled strain naman ito. Tension control section is a cross section in which the net tensile strain in the extreme tension steel at nominal strength is greater than or equal to 0.005. Yan yung ating tension. Ang compression control naman, balance, no? At bala, yun yung limit. Pag sinabing limit, yun yung ceiling. No? Beyond that, below that stress, compression control, of course. No? Sinabi mong limit, meron siyang limit. Sana ba ako? Okay, malapit na tayo mag-example. Na? Ayan na tayo. Now, paano pag dumami pa yung bar mo? Okay, tito ta, padandahan kong in-increase yung bar. Okay, galing dyan, dinagdagan natin. Look at the sea, look at the sea. Dinagdagan natin, look at the sea. Look at the strain. Look at the strain, what's going on if we add more bars? Diba, diba, tinan nyo, para ma-imagine nyo. Huh? Ito yung una. Ito, dumami yung ating bar. Look at the strain. Lumiit yung stress ng strain ng steel. Dumami yung bar. Lumaki yung sea. Lumiit ito. Dumami. No? Dumami na dumami. Hanggang balance. What if dagdagan pa natin? No? Dadami pa siya. Ayun, no? Nako, lampas na ng balance. Lampas na ng balance. Yung FS is no, less than FY already. No? Hindi na to compression, hindi na to ano, hindi na pwede itong formulang ito. Kasi your FS is no longer equal to FY. Yung balance pwede pa. Yung balance pwede pa. Pero dito hindi na pwede. Hindi na pwede gamitin to. Yung fee natin 0.65 na. Yung fee natin dito is already 0.65. Iyan ang investigation. Okay ba? Ha? Pagkagutom na kayo, ha? Kasalanan ko pag ba may mamatay dito. Ha? Okay? Anyway, if you miss this, baka busy kayo, pwede nyo panoorin ulit. Kaya kung may tanong kayo, tanongin nyo na ngayon. Sige, tanong-tanong. Tanong. Eh, baka yung iba dyan, just stay for the raffle. Just stay for the raffle. Yan. Okay? Sige. Sample tayo para maganda. By the way, paano gawin kapag compression controlled? Medyo, sige lang, wag ko na lang munang i-discuss ito, no? Gagamit ka na lang diagram talaga. Anyway, I can discuss this later on. Sa example, yan. Gabali, ang mangyari dyan, ano yung C mo? Gagawa ka ng equation based on mechanics and based on the assumption of the code, and then ano yung C natin, and we will solve for C. Alright? Sige, we will have that later on. Sa example, meron tayong example dito. Pakinig kayo. Ito, example to ng investigation or analysis of rectangular beam, singly reinforced rectangular beam. Given yung dimension, okay, yung ating width natin is 300 mm, effective depth ay 480 mm, FC prime is 34.5, FY is 415. Ang tinatanong ay ang design strength niya. Pag design strength, PMN yan. Pag nominal strength, MN lang. No? So using 4 na 25 mm, tapos iridagan ko, ginawa natin 6, ginawang 825, ginawa natin 828. Tingnan natin what will happen. Kayo dyan, ha? Sige, resume tayo. Resume tayo para makadami tayo. By the way, ito pala yung raw max, kasi ito yung karamihan talaga, 0.75 raw balance. Ito yung 2001 NSCP. Look at the 2001 NSCP, ha? 2001, ito yung party doon sa may RUMAX. Nandito yun, eh. Dito yun, eh. Ano? Sinabi dito. For flexural members and for members subject to combined flexural and compressive axial load, when the design axial strength PPN is less than the smaller of, yan, kumbaga napakiliit, ang ratio provided shall not exceed 0.75 of raw balance. That was in 2001 NSCP. Diba? Kung interpretin mo yan, kapag yung flexural member mo ay napakaliit ng axial load niya or wala talaga, 0.75 raw balance. Okay, ano naman yung sa 2010 tsaka 2015? Ito yun, o. Ito yun. Sa 2010 at saka sa 2015. Asa na ba yun? Asa na ba? Hindi ko na makita tuloy. Ito. For non-pre-stressed beams with PU, hindi na PPN sinabi niya, PU na. No? With PU, which is correct naman, PPN naman, medyo design naman yun, eh. Kaya nga, mali nga yung statement dito, eh. Paano mo axial strength PPN? Parang this has a very vague, parang, ba't ganun? Strength niya? No? hindi dapat yan ang sinabi niya. Medyo mali yan eh. Yung strength niya, less than that. I don't know, pero for me, it's a wrong statement. Anyway, dito naman sa 2015, kung ang PU natin ay less than this, pareho, the strain is at least 0.004. At least, so hindi dapat liliit pa dyan. No? At least. Okay? The strain is at least 0.004. So wala na yung 0.75 raw balance, ha? Para meron kayong, ano, marami dyang nagtatanong, ba't wala na yung 0.75? Ano nangyari? Nangyari, ano? Ayan. Okay. Sige na. Ituloy natin to. So, meron tayong beam, no? Rectangular beam, given yung width na. Binigay ko na lang yung effective depth para wala lang masyadong maraming story. Ah, hindi na natin kukomputin yung effective depth. Ang dami pa itong dapat yung malaman, ha? Ito, summary lang to talaga ng flexure. Okay? Summary lang ng flexure. Alright? Ito yung ating dimension. Ang tinatanong dito ay kung ano yung strength niya. Using una, 4 na 25mm. So first, kunin muna natin yung mga prerequisites like beta 1. Our beta 1, okay? So beta 1, may nagsagot na dito, A tsaka D daw. Alright. Okay, beta 1, sinabi dito, no? Yung FC prime natin is more than 28 mpa, kaya dito tayo. Ito tayo, ito yung gagamitin natin na letter B, yung gagamitin natin na formula. Now you might ask me, sir, ibibigay ba yan sa board exam ang formula? Normally, hindi na. Pero wag muna kayo mag-isip ng ganun sa, wag muna, wala muna ang board exam ngayon. Wala muna. Isip mo lang muna tayo. Ha? Kasi bisa na nagpapahirap sa isang problem kapag you start memorizing it. Because if you're just memorizing it, mahirap pag-memorize. Mahirap talaga mag-memorize. Pero kung unahin nyo yung principle, hahabulin ka ng formula. Ikaw na yung mag-iisip. Madali mong maintindihan ang formula kung alam mo yung principle. Trust me. No? Ganun dapat yung attitude natin habang nag-aral pa tayo. Eh? Okay, yung memorization na yan, kung wala na yan, kung talagang hindi mo na kayang ma-prove, memorize mo na lang, lalo na pag mga empirical. Okay, so ito yung ating beta 1, ha? So, beta 1. Alright, the value is 0.804. Okay, so dapat hindi bababa ng 0.65. Diba? So, yun lang. So, 1. Walang problema. Next, kundin, prerequisites muna, no? Kunin muna natin yung raw balance, raw T, lahat-lahat ng mga dapat natin ma-assess para madali natin makita itong kung compression control ba to, tension control ba to, whatever. Okay, yung raw balance natin. Raw balance, ayan ha, dinared natin yan kanina. So, diretso ko na lang. Kaya na lang mag-check. Ito yung ating raw balance, 0.0336. Kunin ko na lang din yung aking raw T. Ano ba yung raw T? Ito yung single reinforced raw, yung limiting raw na tension control siya. So, beyond that raw, hindi na siya tension control. Yan. Ma-appreciate yung gamit niyan. Okay? Yan, oh. Yan ang value ng roti. Ah, hindi yung pagkain ng Indian delicacy roti. Hindi yun. Okay, pati na lang din yung roaming. Ano ba yung roaming dito, no? Okay, your FC prime is more than 31. Ah, ito yung roaming kanina sinabi ko. Saan ba yun? Pinko muna. Ito. Okay, so ito yung gagamitin natin. Raw na lang, raw. Huwag na lang akong mag-AS. Anyway, isa lang naman yung B natin eh. Hindi naman to T beam. Kaya yung BW natin is equal to B. So, pwede natin gamitin ito. Ito yung gagamitin ko. Actually, kung hindi ka sure, solve mo itong dalawa. Na, solve mo yung dalawang yan. Ang sinabi ng exam, the greater of A and B. Kung ano yung malaki sa kanila, yun ang gagamitin mo. But to save time, if you can remember this value, then makasave ka lang time. Hindi mo na kailangan mag-check pa nila eh. O di kaya, halimbawa, if your FC prime is 28 mpa, 21, then dito ka na diretso. Ha? So, makaka save ng time. Alright. Okay, roaming natin, yan. Roaming na lang gamitin ko. Yan. Alright. So, yun ang mga prerequisites na sinolve natin, ha? Okay lang? Okay lang, mga kapuso. Oh, walang raffle. Yung iba dyan, pag nag-attend lang para sa raffle, nako, walang raffle, sir. Na, mas maganda tong knowledge kaysa sa raffle. Mamaya, mag-raffle tayo. Dagdag tayo raffle. Ayan. Dilipat ka lang yan, ha? Walang daya yan. Okay. Sige daw. then, well, rather than memorizing formula, you can as well na lang siguro imagine this diagram. Imagine nyo na lang to. But really, rather than mag-memorize ka ng formula, I suggest, ito na lang, tinan mo. Madali lang naman mabasahin ito eh. No? Ito yung tensile force easy. Tawagin ko lang ASFS. Huwag muna ASFY. It is yet to be proven. No? Ito yung compressive force in concrete. Di ba? Stress 0.85 Fc prime times the area AB. Di ba? B man lang. AB. And then ito naman yung moment arm niya. Centroid yung centroid niya nasa gitna. So D minus kalahati ng A. Ayan. That's very fundamental. Okay. Kunin din natin yung area ng 1 bar para mabilis, no? Ang area ng 25 mm ay 491 square mm. Sige, part 1 tayo. Apat na 25 mm. Apat. Okay? So, 1964 ang area. Kunin natin yung raw para malaman natin kung ano ba, no? Tension controlled, compression controlled, transition zone. Okay, raw. AS over BD. Okay, look. How much is that? 0.0136. Okay, first, it's above bromine. So, okay. Okay. What if? What if lang? What if? Ang lumabas dito, 0.0031. What if? What if? Sige daw. Let me hear from you. What if ang lumabas dyan, 0.0031, less than bromine? What will you do? Sige daw. Let me hear from you. What will you do? Huh? Para maging interactive yung ating lesson, huwag kayong mahiya. Huwag kayong mahiya. Ay ka uya mo. Hawaray pa. Ay kaud. Pakiana. Huh? Kung gusto rin yung anonymous dito kaysa Padlet. Para walang hindi malaman yung identity ninyo. Ito yung maganda sa online namin. Meron kaming Padlet. No? Meron kaming Padlet that you can anonymously ask question. So, kasi iba, mahihang magtanong eh. Kaya ito yung maganda sa online. Okay, use roaming daw. Roaming will govern. Adapt roaming. Stop. Use roaming. Alright, look. Use roaming. Ang dami nagsabi ng use roaming. Well, is that your fault? No. You stop. You don't have that right. You don't have that right. Huwag mo sabihin, dagdagan mo yung bar. You are not designing. You are just investigating. Imagine niyo, binigay lang sa iyo. Pare, tapos na yung bin namin. Ito yung bar namin. Nang kinimpute mo yung row. Naku! Less than row. Less than roaming. Alam naman, dagdagan mo yung bar mo. Gagamitin mo yung roaming. Dagdagan mo yung bar mo. You can't do that. Ano, ibabarinahin mo yun. You stop. Unless, nagdi-design ka. Kung nagdi-design ka, kumbaga wala pang bar, pwede. Kung nagdi-design ka, yan. I know marami nalilito dyan sa part na yan. Pero intindihin nyo, internalize nyo yung situation. Pinapa-imbisigit ka lang, meron ang bar, huwag mong dagdagan. You will be in danger. Huwag mong sabihin, dagdagan mo yung bar mo. I hope you got the point. Kung hindi, internalize nyo muna para maintindihan nyo. Ano ba internalizing, sir? You should know what you're doing. Not the formula, ha? Iba yung know what you're doing, know the formula, iba, magkaiba yun. Yan, ang pagkaiba, ang difference nga lang, inalam nyo yung formula without knowing what to do. Kaya yun ang big difference, no? Mas maganda pa yun, you know what to do, even if you don't know the formula, kaya. Alright, then, okay, so walang problema yan. Now, ang tanong dito, is it tension control or not? Tingnan natin yung roti natin. O look, ang roti natin, 0.0213. Ano ibig sabihin niya? Maliit ito. Marami ito. 2.13%. 1.36% lang yung roti. Sigurado, maliit yung bar mo. Kapag kunti yung bar mo. Kasi what is tension and compression control? Nagtatag-ubwar kasi yung concrete at saka steel. Dapat talaga matatalo yung steel. Dapat steel must yield first. Ang tawag dyan, under-reinforced. Hindi yung under-reinforced na talagang kinurakot yung steel bar, ha? That's not the meaning of it. Ang ibig sabihin ng under-reinforced, dapat among the two, unang mag-yield ang steel. Kasi pag, before kasi mag-break ang steel, ducting man yung steel, ductile, before siya mag-yield, no? Before siya mag-fail, halimbawa, it will stretch. Iinat muna. So, ang effect niya sa beam, magde-reflect. So before the steel fails, mag-deflect mo na yung beam. Natural, if you are the occupants of the building, nag-deflect yung beam. Alam naman, sasabihin mo, uy, dagdagan niya pa ng load. Nag-deflect yung beam. Ang gandang tingnan. No? Yun ang ductile failure. Mag-deflect mo na siya. E paano kung hindi mag-fail ang steel? Una mag-fail ang concrete. Ang concrete kasi brittle. Kapag nag-fail yan, crushing yan. Without warning. Without warning. So you have to avoid. Even balance has to be avoided. Okay. Sandali ha. Medyo na-interrupt yung aking... Na-interrupt yung live. Pag na-interrupt, ano yung ano natin? Yung signal. Okay, bumalik na. Na-interrupt yung saglit. Yan. It has to be avoided. Alright, sige. So, problema. I mean, continue tayo. Less than roti. So, in other words, tension controlled ito. No? Tension still yields, yes. And then, tension controlled pa. Plus, we can use the formula if you want. Yung Rn, pwede mong gamitin. Pwede mong solvin yung omega. No? Pwede omega. Or, you can just imagine this figure. No? So, compressive force in concrete equals T. So, Cc equals T. Yung Fs natin is Fy. Lalabas itong formula na to. No? Saan galing yan? Saan galing yan? Kaya nga, mas maganda minsan kung hindi ka nagagamit ng formula. 0.25 Fc prime Ab equals As Fy. Kasi na-prove natin na nag-yield yung steel. Tension control nga siya eh. Kapag tension control, siguradong yield yan. No? Alright, so A natin ay ito. Makukuha natin yung A. Na? Kuha natin yung value ng A. The depth of the compression block. Okay, then makukuha mo na yung moment. How? Mag-moment ka rito. Na? Summation of moment or moment about this. So the moment is CC. O pwede rin. Pwede CC times moment arm. Pwede ka rin mag-moment dito. Pwede. Either way. Mag-moment ka dyan. So we have T times moment arm. Any. Dito na lang para mas madali. The tension is ASFY. Kasi we have proven na nag-yield siya. Kasi ang rho niya is more less than rho balance. Actually, less than rho balance nga eh. Less than rho balance. No? So yield talaga siya. No? Okay. So yun. Yan yung ating nominal strength, 353. Hindi letter B ha, nominal yan. Ang tanong dito, design. So, iba yung design, iba yung nominal. Yung nominal galing lang sa section and the material being used. The design is, applyan natin ng reduction factor. So, P natin, we have proven na less than rho T yung ating rho. Tension controlled, so yung P natin is 0.9. Kaya yan ang sagot. 318, letter A ang sagot. Okay ba? Eh? Oh, letter A ang sagot. 318 kilonewton meter. Okay? Okay. Sige, I know, may ibang tanong dyan na masyadong mababaw. Ba't daw naging over 2? Eh? Ba't daw nandyan yung centroid? Ito yung mga tanong na na-encounter namin sa review. Minsan nakakadismaya, pero wala tayong magawa. Pero I hope, pag magtanong kayo, make sure na nandoon na lahat. No? Sir, given ba yung D? May mga ganung tanong sa review eh. Huwag muna yung mga ganun. Alright, sige, continue tayo. Next. Okay ba? Gawin nating anim. At least, meron may idea na tayo. No? Ito yung classic example na complete paano mo i-analyze ang singly reinforced rectangular beam. Alright, check it out. Gawin natin anim. Part 2. So, anim na 25 mm is 2946. So, ano yung rho? ASBD. Yan. Alright. Look, 0.0205. Kung titignan natin, still yields pa rin. Greater than rho balance. No? I mean, less than rho balance. Still yield. Ibig sabihin, huwag yung memorize na greater less than. Isipin ninyo na marami or kakaunti. Mas marami ang steel, lalong hindi siya mag-yield. Kakaunti ang steel, mag-yield siya. Tatalo siya. Pag marami ang steel, hindi mananalo siya. Meaning, hindi siya mag-yield. Kapag kunti, okay. Kakaunti, marami. Relative to the raw balance, kakaunti, it will yield. It will yield. The steel will yield. And other than that, tension control, kakaunti siya kaysa sa tension control, no? 0.0213 yan, 0.0205. Tension control pa rin ito. It will yield, of course. and it is tension controlled. So the solution is basically similar to kanina. So kuha ka ng A, and then kuha ka ng MN, and so on. Okay, you might ask me, sir, can we use the formula Rn omega? Yes. Let me try. Let me try that. Na? So yung rho natin is equal to 0.0205. Okay. Ano ba yung FC prime natin? Lagyan ko lang ng unit ha. FC prime is 34.5 MPa. Ang FY natin ay 415 MPa. Beta 1 natin, ilagay ko na lang din yung beta 1, 0.804. Beta 1. Meron pa nagko-commit minsan. Kung gumagamit yun ng matkat, wala namang matkat sa board. Yes, we know, but kung if you are into solution-oriented ka, ayaw mo ng matkat. Pero matkat kasi napakabilis. Mabilis tayong mag-what if dito mamaya. What if ganito mangyari? What if ganito? Madali natin ma-assess. No? And then yung B natin ay 300 mm. And then yung effective depth, pinigay niya naman, 480 mm. Yan. Okay. Yan na yan, no? So, yung DB natin ay 25 mm. Kaya yung area ng bar natin ay pi over 4.25, ha? Times DB squared. Yan yung area ng isang bar. Okay? So, part 2 na tayo. The number of bars ay 6 na 6 na bar. So yung AS natin ay N times area ng 1 bar. Yan. Gawin natin square mm. And then after that, yung rho is AS over BD. Okay, dagdagan natin ng decimal. Yan. Then, yung omega, if you want, no? Yung omega, pwede, no? Omega is equal to rho times Fy over Fc prime. Yan, ang ating omega. After omega, yung Rn, okay? Rn is equal to Fc prime times omega times the quantity 1 minus 0.59 times omega. Yan, MPa ang unit niyan. MPa. Then after Rn, makukuha mo na yung Mn, nominal strength. Mn is equal to Rn times B times, Rn times B times D squared. Yan, 501. Oh, look, 501. Newton millimeter yung unit yan. Na? And then PMn dial. Anyway, hanggang dyan lang muna tayo. 501.87. Pwede. Mas accurate ito kasi wala tong formula. Ito kasi yung 0.59, ni round off na yan. Naka-round off na yung 0.59 na yan. Tinan nyo kanina, yung part 1, yung PMN natin, no? So yung fee natin, by the way, is 0.9, no? Yung fee natin, ay 0.9. Kaya yung PMN natin, so ano yung PMN? Yun yung design strength. Yan, 451 kilonewton. Kanina, na apat siya kanina, look, 317, not 318. Walang round. Hey, sige lang, magagamit natin itong program ko hanggang mamaya. Sir, parating na po yung free box ko from you. Thank you very much po. Sobra, love you, sir. Wow. Alright. Okay, sige. Okay, anong oras na? Nako, lagpas na tayo. Halapit na, 11 na. No? Nako, 11 na, hindi natin maubos. Alright, next. 8.25 mm. Okay lang ba kayo? Okay lang kayo? Bro, what happens if the calculated rho is lesser than... Okay. Didiscuss namin yan kanina. Kung less than rho mean, you stop. If the rho provided is less than rho mean, you stop. Remember, you are investigating. You are not designing. Huwag mong sabihin, use rho mean. No. You stop. Wala mangyari. Below. When a CRF 5, marami na naghahanap. Sige lang, mayan ang kalaban. Okay, gawin natin 8. 8.25 mm. So 3928 na. Tingnan natin ha. 3928. Sige. So yung row natin ngayon ay magiging ganito. Oh, 0.0273. O tingnan niyo ha. Okay, less than row balance pa rin. Kakaunti pa rin siya. It will yield. Less than row balance. Ito man yung gauge natin kung mag-yield ba o hindi. Pero, marami na kaysa sa roti. Hindi na siya tension control. Nakuha nyo? Kakaunti siya compared dun sa roti. Ano nga yung roti? Yun yung maximum row na tension control yung single reinforced beam mo. Yung row balance naman, yun yung maximum row na mag-yield ang steel. No? Pag mas marami pa dyan, hindi na siya mag-yield. Hindi na mag-yield. Okay, yung row natin, kakaunti. Compared to this, it will yield. But more than the roti, then it is not tension control. Okay. Do not memorize that. Otherwise, talagang mamamoblema ka pag minimorize mo yan. For November po, abot. Yes, abot yan. Na? Okay? Alright, so ganun yung ating row. So less than row balance, I mean greater than row balance, less than row balance, but greater than, greater than roti. So it will yield, but it is not tension control. Fs equals Fy pa rin, but your T is not equal to 0.9 anymore. Huh? So to solve for Mn, the same process. Kuha mo yung A, the formula can be used. Pwede ba solve, pwede magamit yung formula. Kuha mo yung A, ayan, yung A natin. And then, kuha mo yung pwede mong kunin na yung MN. Actually, pwede mong idiretso sa MN ito. No? Dito, kinumpit ko muna yung C. But you may, kung MN lang yung pake mo, you may not solve this C yet. Makukuha mo yung C. Okay? O, tinan nyo. Tinan nyo yung stress ng, okay, after C, tinan nyo yung stress ng tension steel. Ito na, oh. Ito yung stress ng tension steel. Formula, di ba? Ang lalabas dyan ay 649.5. Talagang below siya. Below NA. Below F. Below 1000 MPa. Transition siya. Ito yung formula for T. 0.65 plus 0.85 FS. No? Assuming dito, ha? Ang assumption natin dito is ang ating E, 200,000. No? Yan. Ito yung reduction factor mo. Hindi na siya 0.9. Then, ito yung nominal. Actually, kung nominal lang naman ang habol natin, halimbawa, nominal slit lang, you may not solve this. After getting the value, eh, makukuha mo naman yung MN, just like what we did kanina. Na? Ayan. And then, yung design strength natin ay VMN. Look, ang V natin ay 0.75, kaya 473.55. Yan yung ating design strength. Kuha niyo ba? Ah, tinan natin sa matkan. Ah, what happened there? Ginawa nating 6 na, no? Ah, 8 na ba yun? 8. Ah, ito yung nominal. Nakuha natin ng nominal, 631. Pero mali na to. Mali na to siya. Pwede tayong gumawa dito ng command. No? If anyway, pwede tayo mag-if dyan. But anyway, huwag na lang, tatagal tayo. Mamaya may gagawin ako sa matkan. Alright, naintindihan nyo ba to? Well, another way to solve for the value of V, gagamit tayo ng linear interpolation. You can use your calculator for that. Yung ating programmable calculator, no? Ito yung suggested namin, yung Canon. I know, may mga mas powerful or ibang calculator pa na ano, pero okay na to. Na? Ito 'yon. Kasi ang ano diyan, ang system kasi diyan is kung ang FS, ito yung FS natin, ito yung V. Kung ang FS mo is equal to FY, ang V natin 0.65. Kung ang FS mo ay 1000 MPa, ang V natin is 0.9. So ano ngayon ang F, ang P, kung ang FS natin ay 649.5. So, linear interpolation lang. No? Interpolate tayo. So, tingnan natin. So we will use mode start and then linear. Okay? Pasok tayo ng dalawa. X yung fs, phi yung y yung phi, no? For x fs of fy, ano ba yung fy natin? 415. Ang phi na gagamitin ay 0.65. For fs of 1000 MPa, ang phi na gagaps 1000, ang phi na gagamitin ay 0.9. So ano yung y when x equals 649.5? So we will need our y. Y hat. So 649.5 ups regression, and then y yung solve natin. Y hat. Yun. 0.75. Yan. 0.75. Kuha nyo. Nakuha nyo ba mga kapuso? Ha? Alam, magic? Ah, hindi magic yan. Alam mo lang yung principle. You just let the calculator do the linear interpolation. Linear? Galing naman ito ng linear interpolation. Ha? Okay? Ayan, mga kapuso. Ha? Yeah, 0.75. Okay. Next, ito la. Lumaki pa yung AS natin. Ginawa natin 8.28 mm. By the way, tingnan daw natin yung difference ng answer, ha? Ito ay 473, ani 8.25 mm. Yung anim 451. Tingnan niyo, ha? Tingnan niyo. Dito anim ito na bar, 451. Ito naman 473. Kunti lang. Mga 22 kilonewton meter lang yung nag-gain mo. Nagdagdag ka na ng dalawang 25 mm, ang naging mo lang is 22 MPa, a kilonewton meter. No? Hindi masyado malaki. Kasi tingnan nyo, yes, lumaki yung nominal mo. Yung nominal mo, lumaki, 631. Dito, ang nominal natin, 501. Lumaki ng 100 plus. Di ba? Ang nominal. Pero lumiit naman yung reduction mo. Naging 0.75. Samantala, dito ang reduction factor natin 0.9. Did you see? Na-appreciate nyo ba yung ano? Na-appreciate nyo yung difference, no? Kapag nag-over-enforce ka, yes, lalaki yung nominal mo, pero liliit yung reduction factor mo. Talagang i-discourage yung over-enforced, no? O, tinan lang natin. 8.28 mm na yan. Tinan nyo, ha? Ano yung magiging benefit compared to number 2? Ano yung magiging benefit niya? Well, between part 1 and part 2, malaki yung difference. Malaki pa rin yung difference between part 1 and part 2. Kung titingnan natin, in part 1 kasi, in part 1, apat lang. So, 317. Lagyan mo ito, 318. In part 2, anim. Naging 451. Malaki. Malaki. No? Malaki pa yung kanyang gain. Tingnan natin ang part number 4. Tingnan natin sa number 4. Look. Ay, sandali. Hindi na yan. Dito na tayo. Part 4. 8.28 mm. I know this is quite impossible, impractical for the size of beam. But anyway, just for the purpose of illustration lang. For the purpose of illustration lang. I know parang grabe naman yun, sir. Ang litang beam mo, 8.28 mm. I know that. Pero for the purpose of, discussion, para makita natin. Alright, 4928. Tinan nyo yung row natin. Okay, look at the row. 0.034. Nako, malaki na siya kaysa sa row balance. Malaki na siya kaysa sa row balance. So, sigurado, it will not yield anymore. More than row balance. So, this is 10 compression control. Your Fs is no longer equal to Fy. It will not yield. Yung P natin dito, compression control na ito. 0.65. So we cannot use the formula anymore. Kasi hindi na ito magiging Fy. Hindi na tayo pwede gumamit ng, pwede pa rin yung A. Pwede pa rin yung formula. Pero kaya alam, AS, hindi na Fy. FS na. FS na. Ngayon, anong pa yung, take note, anong yung FS? Anong din yung A? Dalawa yung anong natin, FS at saka A, no? But pwede natin yung dalawang yun, pwede natin ma-express in terms of C. Kasi A being an unknown ay beta 1C, di ba? And FS unknown then can be expressed in terms of C. Di ba? You know, So, okay. Then, equilibrium. Compressive force in concrete equals tension in steel. Oh, compressive force in concrete. Ito yun. Meron tayong A. Equals ASFS. Hindi na FY. Hindi na FY. Okay, what is A? Beta 1C. Diba? Ah, beta 1C. What is FS? Ito yung FS. Formula yan, ha? Formula ito ng FS. Ah, dinerive ko yung kanina. Dinerive natin yung kanina. Yun. Look. Unknown ang C. Unknown ang C. Makukuha natin ang C. 285.3 mm. Ang A natin ay 229.4 mm. Check natin. Ano yung FS? Look. Back natin dito sa formulang ito. 409.5 yung ating FS. Talagang hindi siya nag-yield. Less than FY. Less than FY. Kaya yung MN natin ay, ito yung nominal niya, 736.9. Look at the design. PMN, P is 0.65. 479. Oh, what benefit did you get? Dito, 473. Di ba? Dito sa number 3, 473. Sa number 3, 473 ang strength. 6, 825 mm. Oh, ginawa natin 8, 28 mm. Naging 479. Ha? Useless, di ba? Ay, hindi, di ba? Walang gamit. Dami-dami ka. Kasi lumit. Yes, lumaki ang nominal niya. Lumaki ang nominal, 736. Compared to 631. But, dahil lumiit yung kanyang reduction factor, kaya lumiit din siya. Kaya talagang madi-discourage kang mag-over. Walang gamit. Kapag mag-over ka sa tension control limit. No? Sayang lang yung dinagdag mo na bar. Naintindihan niyo ba, mga kapuso? Ha? Okay lang na. Are you getting... Baka wala kayo naintindihan, ako. Baka sayang oras namin. Nanood pa kami. Ha? Wala din naman pala. Ha? Okay lang ba? Ano naman dyan eh? Pagana. No? Bula-bula ba? Bula-bula. Galing niyo, sir. Oh, char. Ha? Yes, sir. Very well explained. No? Okay. Ayan. Yan ang ating analysis ito. Iba naman yung design. And I'm afraid we cannot do that anymore. No? Okay, we cannot do that. For those who are inclined to math CAD din, I can share this to you, no? Para hindi na tayo mag-assume. Pwede kasi tayong gumawa ng generic na solution. Pwede tayong gumamit ng generic solution talaga, no? Ito yung generic solution natin, ha? Gawin natin lahat function. Hindi na tayo mag-assume-assume. No? Yung ating beta 1, meron naman tayong beta 1, no? Yung A natin in terms of C equals beta 1 times C. Tapos yung FS natin in terms of C, yung compressive force in concrete as function of C is equal to 0.85 times FC prime times A times B. Yan. And then, ito yun. Tingnan nyo, ha? I will do MACAD, no? Yung steel stress function of C. Tingnan nyo, ha? Ito yung command, oh. Minimum of FY and the formula 600 MPa times D minus C over C. Tingnan nyo. Minimum of. So, kumbaga, ang MATCAD will use the lesser value of the two. Kung saan yung maliit sa dalawang yan, yun ang gagamitin ni MATCAD. Na? Ito naman yung magiging tension in steel, T in terms of C. That will be AS times the stress in steel function of C. Yan ang gagadihan. Upsos, bakit naging equal dapat? Well, I've been using MATCAD since the start of MATCAD. I've been a reviewer since 1991. I used to handle all the subjects in our review. Ako ikaw nag-handle lahat before. Kaya ngayon, hindi na kaya kasi medyo marami na. Ups. Yeah. AS times... Ay, wala pa pala akong AS. FS. Kaya pala nag-error. Wala pa pala akong AS. Kit natin to. Hindi siya mag-error. Ayan. Tapos, unknown yung C, di ba? Unknown yung C. So, gagawa tayo ng equation given. Guess muna. Mag-guess value tayo ng C. Guess value 100 mm. And then, i-gawin natin yung equation based on equilibrium given. No? As I mentioned, process zero. No? The compressive force in concrete, function of C, equals the tension in steel, function of C, and then C equals find C. Para, yan. Yan yung C niya. And then, kuha na yung A. A, function of C. Para ma-check natin. Alright? I'm making a generic program na kahit anong bar, tension control man rin di, na? Pati yung FS. Function of C. Okay, pwede tayong gumawa ng formula for phi. Okay, so if Fs C is greater than or less than, alam mo na, less than or equal, oops, okay lang kayo dyan? Less than or equal to Fy 0.65. Otherwise, yung formula, no? Point, oops, the formula is greater than. Sandali. Another if. If Fsc, so kung hindi siya, dali, I'm getting the logic, baka ano tayo, na less than 1000 MPa. Ayan, less than 1000 MPa transition zone, na transition zone, ano yung formula? Point 65 plus point 35 times Fy, Fs minus Fy all over 1000 MPa minus Fy. That's the transition zone. Alright? Otherwise, 0.9. Nako, sorry. Ahay. Pa yung bracket ko. Nako! Tumagal na tayo. Sorry ha. Else, sandali. Okay, para hindi ako ma-confuse. Ito na lang, para na-pressure ako. Sa bracket 'yon, ano. Pwede ako pwede kasi ako gagawa ng ano na lang eh, ng anyway. Kunin ko lang yung muna yung P1. 0.65 plus 0.35 times Fs minus Fy. Napapressure ako sa inyo. Over 1,000 MPa. Agad yung feeling kapag na-pressure ka na. Ha? Naku, 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 naku. Na-pressure ka na. FSC. Yeah, para mahimay natin na mabuti yung ating... Yan. Yan. Okay? So, ito na yung P natin. Okay. If FSC is greater than 1,000, greater than or equal, is greater than or equal to 1,000 MPa, the value of P is 0.9. Otherwise, okay, another if FSC is less than FY, equal or less than FY, ayan, then 0.65. Otherwise, P1, ayan, para hindi nahaba yung, okay, other or else P1. Close parenthesis, yun na. Yan. Tama ba yung 6? Correct ba? Greater than 0.9. Otherwise, less than or equal to FY. Mali yata. Ah, tama. Ano ba yung actual FS? Okay pa kayo? Ah, okay. Mali. If FSC. Ay, okay. Sorry. FSA ito. Yan. Yung FSC pala, evaluated niya na. Okay, ito yung kanina. Ito yun, no? Then, yung MN natin is equal to MN is equal to 0.85 times FC prime times A times B times the moment arm D minus A over 2. Hintayin nyo lang, meron akong ipapakita sa inyo na ayun, what if na, tapos PMN. Alright, ito na, ha? Oro natin para ma-view natin lahat. Okay. So, kanina, apat, no? Apat. Okay, so apat, yan, 318. So, nakita natin dito that the actual tension in steel is 1899. Kaya naging tension control siya. Yung P niyang ginamit ay 0.9. Ah, tension control siya. Ginawa natin, okay, ito yung nominal strength niya, 353. Ito naman yung kanyang design strength, 318. Ginawa natin, 6. What happened? 1,066. So, tension control pa rin. Ha? 0.9 pa rin yung P. Ito na yung naging design strength niya. 451. Tapos, ginawa natin 8. Ayun, naging transition zone na siya. Dapat dito 0.65. Mali ito. No. FSA ito. Ayan. Okay, ito na yung ating FSA. Alright. Okay. Yan, 0.75 yung kanyang reduction factor. 0.75 yung kanyang Alright, 0.75 juga yang naging reduction factor, itu yung naging 4.70, tandaan nyo ha, 4.73. Oh, halimbawa, gawin natin 10.25 mm, what will happen? Okay, tandaan nyo ha, 4.73 yung kanyang design strength ha. Oh, ginawa natin 10, I know, marami na masyado yan. At tinan nyo. Oh, 4.78 lang yung naging strength yan. Diba? Napakakunti ng ano, napakakunti. Kaya, pero between, halimbawa, tatlo lang, between tatlo. Kung tatlo lang, tatlong 25 mm, alright, bali yung F, sandali, i-check ko yung, assume yun, parang lapas din natin ng roaming. O, 2, 2, 4, 4. Apat yan, ha? At tatlo. O, ginawa natin apat, naging 318. So, malaki yung diferensya. No? 318. Ginawa natin 5. Pwede nyo gawan yan ng ano? Pwede nyo gawan ng graph yan. Ginawa natin 5. No? So, naging 386. Okay. Ginawang 6. No? So, tension control pa rin. 451. No? 451. Okay? Ginawa natin 7. Ano na? Transition na siya. 470. Did you get that? Yan. Ganun na matkad. Kita yung program niya. Yung program niya. It will work. Singly reinforced. Pwede kong gawin pa yan. Doubly reinforced. I have a program for that. Alright. Yan. Okay. Anong oras na? Nako. Lagpas na sa oras yun. 11:29 na. 11 yung usapan natin. 11:30 yung ginawa kong 11:30. Kaya lang mag-11:30 na. So, gusto niyo ba magkaroon ng part 2 ulit? Ha? Part 2 tayo, design. Tapos part 3, dagdag natin. Kung nasa sa inyo yun, oh, sir, sana yung winner sa raffle. Ha? Raffle muna tayo. Mag-raffle. Yes, sir. Gusto daw nila ng another part. No? Yes po, sir. Sige. Okay ba? Are you getting it? Ha? Nakatulong ba ako sa inyo? Ha? Nakatulong ba ito sa inyo? Okay? Ganito kami sa review. Ganito yung aming style sa review. So ito, meron tayong interaction. Kaya maganda yung online. I've been in the review profession for 30 plus years. No? Dito lang ako nakakita ng mga question dito sa online namin. Kasi ang dami nagtatanong sa face-to-face. Kasi mahihiyang magtanong. No? Mahihiyang magtanong sa face-to-face. Kaya wala masyadong interaction. Dito ang ganda. No? Tama. I'm very happy. That is enough. Kahit hindi kayo mag-idol service center namin, okay lang. Oh, kung nakatulong tayo, go. Walang problema yan. Walang pinipiling review center to. Kahit saan review center kayo. Okay. Sige. Grapple ulit tayo. Natuto pa kayo. Binigyan pa kayo ng book. Grabe naman. Sige lang. Okay, another lucky winner. 50% discount sa review. Number 221. Okay. 221. Sir, ano pong software yan? MatCAD. Yung dating luma na MatCAD to. But this works. I like this one. Lumang MatCAD to. 221. Hindi software to. Program. Ikaw gagawa ng program. No? Okay. 221. And you are... Uy, Bohol Island. Baiso. Kabahog John Lawrence. 50% discount. Kabahog John Lawrence. Ha? Sir, same style po ba na ginawa nyo ngayon yung nandoon sa JTC YouTube nyo, 500? Similar. Actually, nasa YouTube channel namin. Yung lahat na discuss nyo doon, akin man yung mechanics, saka strength, saka concrete. Ganito. Pero maybe the sample, the style changes. Ha? Okay, sige. Kabahog John Lawrence. Kabahog John Lawrence. Are you there? Para may raffle ulit. Iba yung ano niya, iba yung gusto niyo, raffle lang. Oh, kabahog. Nandiyan ka ba? Wala. Ha? Na count to 5. 1 2 3 4. Ay, by the way, sa face-to-face review, yung lahat ng quizzes, ano 'yun? Sa face-to-face review, lahat ng quizzes ay online. Pero meron din kaming exam na gagawin namin sa in person. Okay, yes, kabahog, you are here, present ka. All right, sige, another winner. All right, another winner. Okay, 319. Miranda, oh, University of Luzon, Daguban City, Pangasinan. Miranda Reni Jr. Miranda Reni Jr., okay, nanalo ka ng dalawang libro. Are you here? Miranda? Miranda Reni? Okay. Nakikita ko na sa monitor ko yung pangalan mo. In a count of 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, Miranda, extension konti, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Alright, sorry. Okay, sige, next lucky winner, 304. Oh, Far Eastern University, Grimaldo Christian Joy. Grimaldo Christian Joy. Ah, Grimaldo. Grimaldo? Ah, are you here? Grimaldo Christian Joy? Alright. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Kapag nasa Cebu, Tagalog, Tagalog, Tagalog. Yes, Tagalog yung salita namin dito. Of course, may marami kaming Ilonggo dito. Hindi kami pwede mag-Cebuano kahit wala kaming Luzon. Hindi pwede kasi may Ilonggo, may Boray. Dapat neutral tayo. Ha? So, Cebuano. Grimaldo, wala. Alright, another. Marami ng, ano, marami ng umuwi yata. 138. Another number, 138. Okay, University of Santo Tomas, Sebastian Crizel. Ha? Sebastian Crizel, UST. Sebastian Crizel, go, go, go. Para tayong nasa Wawa Win, oh. Wawa Win, Sebastian Crizel. Yan, nakikita ko na sa monitor yung pangalan mo. May kunting delay lang yung live feed namin. Ang kagandahan kasi sa Facebook, madaling gamitin, no? Madaling gamitin siya. Baka sabihin niyo ba, ang low-tech nyo naman, ba't hindi kay Teams or what? Sa probinsya, mahihina yung signal. Kaya Facebook ang pinakamadali, tsaka mamura yung data. Practical lang kami. Lahat ng replay namin ay nasa website namin. May website kami. Ito yung website namin, no? Let me show you our website. Login muna ako. Na? Papasok muna ako sa website namin. Sebastian, wala pa ba? Wala pa si Crizel Sebastian. Alright. Dali ha. Papasok ako sa website namin. Ayan. Okay, ito yung aming website. So, nandito lahat ng mga lectures, mga exam. Meron kayo sariling dashboard ninyo, no? Meron kayo sariling dashboard ninyo, no? Dashboard. Ayan, makikita nyo calendar. Nandiyan yung mga events. Nandiyan yung mga gagawin ninyo, yung mga lectures. Okay? Nandyan din yung aming, may mga additional resources dyan. No? Meron tayong book dito, like halimbawa, Impisad. Okay? May mga additional resources dyan sa website natin. No? Gusto mong tinan yung party moving load, may mga formulas dyan. No? May mga videos din dyan, halimbawa, regarding buckling. No? May mga videos din yan, makikita nyo. Regarding that. Yan sa website. Kapag enroll kayo sa aming review center. Yan. May mga formulas yan. Maraming resources. No? Yung mga calculator techniques. No? Exploring calculator. Makikita mo dyan. Sa dashboard yan. Sariling dashboard din nyo. Meron tayong sariling website. Okay? Well, if you want to learn more on how to enroll, if you click visit our grtserve.com, we have here our tutorial. May tutorial kami dito on how to make an account, how to purchase a course, Yan. How to make an account, how to purchase a course, how to pay, nandiyan lahat ng information sa aming website. And by the way, bago ko makalimutan, isigit ko na lang to, I know gutom na kayo, yung aming offers, no? Yung aming offers sa review natin this coming June. Very quick lang. Ito lang yung ano ko. Mga interesado kayo, no? Meron naman yung mga hindi from Cebu, you cannot come to Cebu, meron kaming full online. Ito yung aming pure online class, no? The online review will start on June 5 up to September 9. The basic fee is 9,000. But if you enroll early or before, you can, pwede ka naman review lang. Pwede rin refresher lang. Pwede rin review and refresher. Kung review ka lang, wala kang balak mag-refresher, you can avail of 20% discount if you pay full on or before May 29. The full payment is 7,200. The required, the minimum down payment is 3,000. So if you can pay before on or before May 29, ang babayaran mo na lang is 4,200, making it 7,200. Pwede ka rin mag-installment. Pwede rin, no? Kung wala ka bang balak, hindi ka baka nag-aalanganin ka pa, hindi ka pa makakagraduate, pwede ano lang muna, down payment, and then every course, kasi hanggang 4 courses yan, tag 2,000. So the total is 9,000, pero installment siya. Ano ba yung courses? Mamaya i-spring ko yung courses, no? Ito naman yung pure online refresher namin. 11,000 yung base price natin. If you want refresher lang, pwede rin. If you pay on or before September 11, ang babayaran mo na lang total is 8,800. The minimum down payment again is 3,000. At then babayaran mo before September 11, maka-avail ka ng 20% discount. Yan. Or pwede mo ring i-installment yung refresher mo. Wala kang review, refresher lang. Pwede rin installment. Ito naman yung aming payment. Na? Or if you want na review plus refresher ka, meron kaming package. So instead of 20,000, review is 9,000, refresher is 11,000, option E yan, 40% discount. No? 12,000 na lang ang review and refresher, pero dapat it has to be fully paid on or before April 18. 3,000 ang minimum down payment mo. The rest of the 9,000, babayaran mo on or before April 18. Okay, a total of 12,000. 40% discount yan. Anong pagkakaiba ng review under pressure? Yung aming review talagang discussion, gaya ng ginawa natin ngayon. Discussion yan, full, from basic to complex. Ang refresher namin ay weekly pre-board. Pre-board every week. May pre-board, exam ng pre-board. Ang kagandahan yan, before kami mag-lecture ng sa mga exam namin, meron kaming stats. Kompleto ng stats namin. Talagang hindi kami magle-lecture kung wala kaming statistics. Ibig sabihin, alam na namin kung how did the students react to the different questions given in the exam. Hindi lang yung alam namin na yun yung highest, yun yung lowest, hindi. Pati yung stats, every problem, alam namin ilan yung nakakuha. Saan yung mahirap, ano yung madali, no? Ito yung courses kasi. Yung regular review namin, 14 weeks yan. So ginawa namin, dinivide namin yan into 4. Yan, no? Ginawa namin, dinivide namin into 4. 4 courses lahat. Course 1, course 2, course 3. Ito yung regular fee niya. If you will pay it in installment. 3,000, 2,000, course 2, course 3. Continuation lang yan. No? And then, kung if you want to avail of the discount, yan, 9,000 lahat yan. Kung if you pay on or before May 29, kung review ka lang, ito yung babayaran mo. Kung review lang, ha? Review lang. Pwede. Or on report May 29, ang total na babayaran mo is 7,200. Babayaran mo, review lang. Wala pa kasali refresher. Right? Okay. Ito naman yung online refresher namin. Okay? So, 9 weeks, divide namin yan into 3. Course 1, course 2, and course 3. Okay, the regular payment is 11,000. But if you pay full on or before September 11, ang total na babayaran mo na lang ay by 8,800. 3,000 na down payment, 5,800 na additional payment, 8,800 on or before September 11. Kung refresher ka lang. Kung balak mo mag-review tsaka refresher, pwede. Ito yun. Ito yung regular payments. No? Okay? So, if you can avail of that package, yung option E, ito yun. No? The 20% discount, but the deadline is April 18. So, instead of total of 20,000, ang total na babayaran mo na lang is 12,000. enroll ka muna ng course 1 and then tsaka na lang pwede mo nang bayaran yung 9,000 kumbaga before April 18. Ayan. And then yan, ito naman yung aming on-site. Yung on-site namin discounted na kasi to. Ito yung face-to-face class namin, no? Ang review is 6,000, ang repression ay 6,000. Dalawa yung schedule namin, MWF at saka TTHS. Bali, paano mag-enroll? Ito yun, meron dito sa ano, tinan nyo na lang sa tutorial, ha? Pwede kayo mag-enroll sa website. Pero kung hindi kayo techie, meron naman sa tutorial, mabilisan na lang to. Pwede kayo mag-send ng message doon sa aming Facebook page. No? Send us a message, inquire about the rates, about the what. Pwede kayo doon. Kung hindi kayo comfortable sa aming tawag dyan, sa aming website, pwede kayo mag-message lang. Send mo lang yung page kami na mag-endorse sa iyo. No? Ayan. Okay, ito yung face-to-face namin. Bilisan ko na lang. Ito yung aming schedule. MWF, meron tayong full online, daily, MWF, alternate day is face-to-face, alternate is online. Ganon yung aming setup. Ah, ganon yung aming setup ng face-to-face. Pwede ka rin mag-full online. Pag full online, makukuha mo na rin lahat. Ah, dito lang, may face-to-face component tayo. Ah, may face-to-face component tayo. Our location in Cebu is in Banawa. Actually, anong difference? Yung aming online is kompleto yun. Natin yung face-to-face, nasa classroom kayo. Similar yung lecture, although may konting additional, no? Kasi available din naman yung sa online, and above all yung exams. Pwede rin yung i-take ng face-to-face. Yeah. And, pero yung, kumbaga yung topics na makover, the same. Examples, maybe may additional doon talaga sa face-to-face. Pero yung topics are the same. No? Okay, so hindi pwedeng face-to-face lang. Hindi din pwede face-to-face lang. Dapat only yung nag-online ang pwedeng kumuha ng face-to-face. Hindi pwede face-to-face lang. Kukulangin yung ano mo. Kukulangin talaga. Kasi yung components niya, may nandoon pa rin sa online. Ginawa lang na face-to-face yung iba. Ang location namin is in Banawa. Ito yung location namin dito. Meron kami new location, but I doubt. Sana mahabol namin this June, but we are still completing the government requirements for occupancy. We have our own building na. Ah, ito yung proposed plan. Sana maibigay na lahat ng permits, ng mga clearances para magamit. Ah, ayan. Alright. Sige. So, balikan natin ulit yung raffle. Balikan natin ulit yung raffle. Okay, wala si Sebastian. Another lucky winner. Oh, 339. Oh, University of Cebu, Laurente Janice Rose. Laurente. Yes, may mga handouts sa face-to-face. Meron free books tayo, by the way. Dalawang free books sa review, dalawang free books sa refresher. Ha? Sir, pag MWF schedule po, tapos face-to-face yung achievement test, every Saturday online po ba namin matitake yung achievement test? Okay, online, yes, online. Pero meron din kaming schedule na face-to-face test. We will have it na face-to-face exam. Yung face-to-face rate nyo, yung 6,000, yes, buong review na yon. Yung repressure din is 6,000. Pero only those enrolled in online ang makakuha ng face-to-face. Hindi pwede face-to-face lang. Bali kung halimbawa, kukunin mo yung option E, 12,000 review repressure. 10,000. Review repression na yun, online. Mag-review ka, bayad ka ulit ng 6,000. Para baka, mag-face-to-face ka pala. Para baka attend ka ng face-to-face. Kung mag-repression ka pa, another 6,000 for face-to-face repression. Ha? Kung total lahat talaga, online review plus face-to-face review and repression, discounted yung online mo, abot ka sa April 18, mahulog siya na 24,000 lahat. Kayo po ba designer? Of course. Dali lang naman yan. Hindi naman mahirap designing. Okay, Laurente. Laurente Janica. Wala yata. Wala na. Laurente Janica Rose. Okay, alright. Wala. Walang nag-message. Hindi ako nakita. Laurente. Wala. Okay, another winner. another name, P49. Oh, Silliman University, Dagatan Alberto. Dagatan Alberto. Dagatan Alberto. Eh? Dagatan Alberto. Oh, nakikita ko na. Okay, para matapos tayo. Dagatan Alberto. Ha? Alberto, okay. Good, present. Congratulations, no? All right, and last winner, 50% discount. Last winner, 50% discount, review and refresher online. All right, 266. Bariduque State College, Regencia, Irish Joy. Regencia, 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 Irish Joy. Regencia, Marinduque State College. Regencia, are you here? Are you still here? Ha? Huh? Message agad. Oh, nakikita ko na, Regencia, Irish Joy. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Nako, nako, nako. Ha? Huh? Okay, wala, wala, wala. Marinduque. La. Alright, another number. 165. Makahabol ka ba? Wala na. 165. Oh, Sorsogon State University. Dichoso Josel. Dichoso Josel. So, yung mga Tagalasun dyan, area, kahit sa ang lupalop ng Pilipinas, pwede kayo online. Online. Well, ayan. Subukan nyo lang. No? Hindi naman siguro. Malaga, meron kami. Lahat lang lecture is live via Facebook. Replays doon sa website. Replay na yun. Exams nandoon. May mga additional handouts pa doon. May mga additional problems pa doon sa aming online. Okay? Kung bala kayo sa Manila, gusto nyo subukan kami online, walang problema. No? Walang problema. No? Alright. Sige. Dichoso. Dichoso. Okay. Eh? Wala pa? Alright. Another name. Marami niya itong umuwi. No? Okay. 30. Oh, Davao Oriental State University. Baginsodon Laila. Okay, Baginsodon Laila. Ha? Huh? Baginsodon. Wala pa rin. Tinitingnan ko kasi dito sa ano. Dito sa monitor ko. Baginsodon. Ha? Huh? 1, 2, 3. Nako. Nako, nako. Wala. Wala, wala, wala. Okay. Bigyan ko ng pabor yung unang nag-file. Number 1. Hmm. Aha, number 1. Sige. USA. Balano, Kenneth Bryan. Balano, Kenneth Bryan. Nako, parang pamilya ko sa pangalan. Balano Kenneth Bryan. Balano. Okay, Balano, parang pamilyar ako sa pangalan. Na? No, number 1 talaga 'yan, ha. Siya yung unang nakapag-fill up, na? Siya yung unang nakapag-fill up. 1. Wala. Balano. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10. Pwede mo ba mag-change ng section sa PCBase? Yes. Kapag nakapili na kayo ng section doon sa website namin, as long as vacant pa yung ibang section, pwede kayong magpili ng kahit saang section pipili. Pwede kayong maglipat. Tama. Alright. Okay. But basta hindi pa puno yung section na yun, ha? Alright. Another number, yung 100. Ah. CIP, Aznar Michelle Jane. Aznar Michelle Jane. Ah, ito ako na pumili ng number, no? Number 100, Aznar Michelle Jane. Aznar Michelle Jane, are you present? Sina, para matapos na tayo. Ha? Okay. Wagyo. Ha? Wala agyo. Aznar. Ha? dadami ng puro 70. At dapat wala pa rin. Ha? Okay? Akin na lang po, 0. Be? Be, any number? 367. Ah. Virgin Milagrosa University Foundation, Sanchez Veronica Flor. Sanchez Veronica Flor. Virgin Milagrosa University Foundation. Ako na lang naglagay ng number. Okay. Sanchez, kami na lang claims absence, sir. Sana nga, sana all. Sanchez Veronica Flor. Oh, 425 daw. Ah. 425, may request dito, 425. Ha? Sanchez Veronica Flor, wala pa rin. Alright, wala magawa, 425. Sige, pabigay ko yung ano, request mo, baka ikaw to. Sir Bas, ikaw pa yun. Sir Bas, hindi yata. Ang saya. Oh, Sir Bas Shelly, si Emyo. Sir Bas, Sheila Ann Marie. Sheila Ann Marie, Sir Bas. Ha? 50 daw. Oh, John Paul Philip. Ah, nanonood ka ba? PJ, JP. Ah, may pamangkin ako dito. Si PJ, special mention. Oh, kumusta na dong? Ha? Maganda yung ano dito? Magandang boses ito. Ha? Manang-mana sa akin. Ha? John Philip. Yay, si Emyo. Uy, si Emyo. 321. Sir Bas, wala. Wala pa rin. Ha? Oh, may request dito. 467. May nag... 143 daw. Sige, 143. 143. Hmm. Campo Mayor. Okay. Ah, dyan, Philip. Ha, ha. Ah, Campo Mayor. Ha? Campo Mayor Jetro. Ano ba yan? Campo Mayor. Dami ng number dito. Ha? Di nyo alam yung number ninyo. Okay. Campo Mayor Jetro. Wala. Wala pa rin. No? Okay. Wala pa rin. Sige, sige. Go. Ibang number. Oh, may request. 460. Sige, 460. Oh, 460. Oh, Sigera. Ah, okay. Sigera Joven. Camarines Sur. Sigera, wala pa rin. Wala, Sigera, Sigera. Ah, Sir Bas, ngayon ka pa nag-message. Nako, nako, lumampas yung oras mo. Pero, napagod na lang ako. Sige, Sir Bas, ano ba yung number mo, Sir Bas? Ilalagay ko na lang. Sir Bas. Baka huli yung ano niya. Huli yung... Ano ba yung number kanina? Ilang iti-tiktok ko na lang. Na? Okay. Wala na. Nalampasan ni Sir Bas. Anyway. Sige, ang saya. Kasi pagbigyan kita, Mr. Sigera. Oh, ano 50% discount din? 50% discount. Sige. Pagbibigyan kita, Camarines, or 50% discount, review, refresher ka online. Ha? Sigera, pagbibigyan kita. Ha? Pagbibigyan kita. Ayan. Ha? Alright. Aha, ako din, sir. Sige. Okay. Sige, magpa-parto pa tayo. Online. Yes, online yan. Online. Online review and refresher, 50% discount. Sige lang, when have part 2, we will discuss yung, i-continue natin. Although, anyway, mapapanood nyo pa naman din tong video, nasa, ano natin, no? Nasa Facebook group natin. You can watch it. And then later on, itatransfer namin yan sa YouTube. So, doon nyo na sa YouTube makikita yung video. Okay ba? Eh? Okay ba dyan, mga kapuso? Okay? Alright. Sige. So, raffle part 2 na naman. Okay. So, salamat sa lahat. Sana may natutunan kayo. Ha? Marami kayong natutunan. Tinan nyo lang. Anyway, code. Sa code lang natin binasi lahat. Sa code lang. Walang, I don't know kung may na-misinterpret ako. Pero, yun. Binasi lang natin sa code. So, thank you so much, everyone. And I hope you learn a lot. And see you sa next. No? Meron pa tayong next batch. Okay. Alright. Schedule lang namin. We will announce it soon. Okay. So, again, bye-bye. And, okay. Last time na. Alright. Sige. Bye-bye. Ingat kayo lahat. Ingat.